Ben Thorp is a 51-year-old man who hails from Portal to Hell, an incest capital of the United States, Rhode Island. 7 months ago, in 2022, Ben decided to turn himself, wife, daughter-wife, and five children into YouTube content. Since selling his property in 2019, Ben has burned through $600,000, leaving only a bit over $100,000 left for his family that have no jobs, his wife has left him, and his children now have a permanent reminder in the future to watch how he burned down their lives. Welcome to the Wild Thorpberries.
Like dominating a woman.
Right.
Like, I don't really like beating the shit out of a woman. I don't like it. I had to correct Grace today, like very roughly by like.
Oh, really? You gave Honey Bunch a real through? Yeah.
Oh, she could be like, so Honey crazy. Bunch, she gets that. It from her mother, right? It's at the core of marriage, you moron.
Giving?
All right. Fuck you. Fuck you. May you rot in hell for saying that. Fuck you!
I don't know. I think the core of marriage is two souls coming together as one.
Yeah. I tell you, way, way back, you know, and I'm not saying I'm her husband. I wasn't. It was a mistake. But way, way back, she was in the car with me before any kids were involved.
Yeah.
She was saying, am I the prettiest girl? Am I the prettiest girl? And I said, I've got an answer for that. I pulled over the car to the side of the road. We were on a highway at a rest stop. I took her down to the trees. I took my belt off, and I didn't beat the shit out of her, but
well,
I was
that's
like,
good. Your good. Good.
The point, okay? And I don't know what I'm... So this is the point. The point is, you guys are kind of right. There is something incestuous going on, all right? It's true.
If you're a girl and you're not connected to your dad, you need to go find your dad and suck his dick.
Can go get the boys over here, right? That's your job, bitch. Hit the streets and bring back some customers. Am I right?
Hollywood Ben Thorp. My ex Hollywood Ben Thorp. It's just like, it's coming.
Ow! Fucking bitch. Get up. My scream!
Okay. That was a...
I'll refer you to my first supercut on the Thorps here, and leave a link in the description if this is your first time hearing of them. I want to pick up around where that left off, for December 28th, 2022. John Thorp, Ben's son, appeared on a few of the Thorp streams prior to this. However, it was actually Ben forcing his son onto these streams at the time, threatening his living situation. At this time, John had just had knee surgery and was on crutches when he decides to confront his father in a call.
Right. Okay. So you guys have a problem. Why aren't you working together?
No, we don't have a problem. They have a problem, and you do too. It's called stupidness, and you all have it.
John, don't you think you could get a wheelchair?
What are you talking about?
A wheelchair is what I'm.
Why would I get a wheelchair? I can walk around with crutches. I just can't do anything really.
Why not?
Because I can't bring something from one area to another with crutches.
Oh my God.
There's nothing to fucking eat up here anyways. You need somebody to like help you if you're using crutches. You need somebody around you. Nobody like uses crutches by themselves.
Well, John, can you sit in a chair? I mean, you're telling me
you don't even know what you're talking about. You don't do anything. All you do is sleep all day. You just sit in your bed laying down like a loser. I move more than you at this point, even though I have a leg injury. You don't even move, and you're a fully functional adult.
You won't let me talk. This is
John. John,
your sister Grace is available. She's nimble.
Yeah, I'm not going to ask you guys to do that stuff. Because you're going to just use it as a power game, because that's all you guys do. It drives me crazy. All you did from the first second that I got this leg injury was use it as a power game against me, and I hate it.
The point John is making about everything turning into a power game is a great point. Because of Ben seeing Courtney and John, his wife and son respectively, as the enemy, every conversation or interaction that I've ever seen them have has been some type of power game, whether it's to gain something or to manipulate them or to embarrass them. There's always a power game going on.
That's why
all a power trip for you guys. Look, I'll dangle this in front of your face the entire time. Look, I'll dangle food in front of you. Look, I'm dangling this stuff in front of you.
Anything in front of you?
I'm not doing that game. I'd rather starve and play into your little power game where I have to say sorry all the time, or you're gonna not feed me.
John, you said
John, what the
fuck?
You don't
give me any food when you come up here. You gave me brownies that were left over last time.
What the fuck is wrong with you? What the fuck is wrong with you? Why are you such an asshole all the time?
How am I an asshole all the time? You don't even talk to me. All you do is cry. All you do is cry and make weird comments on the YouTube channel about how I suck dick or whatever. That's what you're
doing. Isn't it funny that your knee injury? Where'd you get that from?
It's like the most cringy comments ever, and nobody laughs. Nobody laughs. Have you ever noticed that nobody thinks you're that funny? You're not really a funny guy. You're annoying.
Okay, John. John, what
I don't know
the
what this whole like. Oh, let's fix you now, buddy. Like, I don't need your help in any way. You don't help me. You never helped me. You always just have been sitting on the sidelines like a retard, waiting for other people to complain.
John, what I'm saying is,
I was complaining before I got the leg injury. I was getting myself food. I was feeding your children. You treat your daughter like your mommy. Is that nice, baby? Baby
John,
boy,
you want a sandwich?
Like the way you're talking to me. Stop! Stop talking
John,
to me like that.
John, you would like to get.
I hate you.
Nobody likes your dynamic together. You suck. You're just depressing to watch.
Grace, John's sister, is 10 feet beneath him and can get him a sandwich.
No, you can't. You use that as a game. I'm not playing that game. Where else am I getting food? Nobody's getting fed up here. Why don't you just not come up here then? I don't even know why you're coming up here. That's not the deal, that you get to come up here at 4 a.m., 5 a.m., 6 a.m., 3 p.m.
I never go up
and you don't give anybody food except yourself, and you're selfish. That's what's going on. You get to come up here and ruin everybody's time whenever you come up here.
Shut
up. Here 7 times a day, and then at midnight, and then at 3 a.m., and then at 6 a.m., and then at 8 a.m., and then at 12 p.m., and every second of the day you're going to eat? What is wrong with you and not offer anybody food? Ridiculous.
John, I never go up there. Is that correct?
Yeah, I know, because you're a weirdo. And you don't even talk to your children.
John, you told me that if I enter those premises, you have...
No, I never said that to you.
By calling the police on me.
If you're going to threaten to kick me out unfairly just because you felt like it, because you think that you have this upper hand, you're getting a good deal up here, if anything. I'm paying half your rent, and you're not doing anything for it except having two of your children live up here tormenting me. That's not a very good deal for me. And I don't know why I have to be so incredibly grateful for it. Independence.
I'm
living at home still. That's why what is so great about living here?
Do you
it's
not
basically
think,
just living at home, but without the support of your mother if you get injured?
Correct.
No, I'm a victim of your situation that you forced me to be in. Yeah.
Me, you're a victim of Grace. You're a victim of your two brothers who are
your roommates.
Yeah,
but it all comes down to you.
Who aren't you?
Best guy ever. You suck. I think
I'm
you
a
have
great
failed
guy. Yeah, you're
so
wrong.
Many
I'm
times.
A great guy.
You fail. You act like you're not. It's not even Grace just that, because I don't have a problem with people who fail. I really actually respect the Abyssinia thing. I know you think I hate you for that, but I respect that you did that. I respect a lot of things that you've done, but you're the just the relationship that you have with me throughout that whole thing. Thank you, man. I love you.
Yeah, I am a great dad.
Everybody should be grateful to you because you're the God of everybody. Everybody should be grateful to you.
Everybody should say sorry to you too,
including random internet people like the Ortho Bro. He should say sorry to you and that he's so sorry. Oh, I'm so sorry for what I've done to you. What did he do to you? That's why you don't have any friends because you think everybody owes you something.
John says you should take a shot. Not everybody owes you something, Benny boy.
Maybe you owe some people some things and you don't give them anything.
Hey, buddy. Be super respectful to me.
What is there here that I'm supposed to respect? You're an insolent fucking asshole.
You don't respect me at all. I don't have to give you that much respect.
What is there worthy of respect here?
My father, if you don't give me any respect as even a person.
What is there that you're doing that is worthy of respect?
That's why, and you're a loser, and I'm not. How about that? That's a loser thing to do. Just sit in bed all day having your daughter bring you food and then crying on internet streams about how much you hate her. Okay, guy, we get it. You're the traditional man. You've won in life. No, you suck.
I'm winning. I'm winning. I'm winning even more. And you should join my team because what you're doing
You're not a winner, Ben. Benny boy, you're not a winner. You're a loser.
You shouldn't refer to me that way in life.
You've lost.
You should not refer to me that way.
I don't want to be on a loser team.
Well, I'm not the one who sounds gay. I don't sound gay either. I'm not the one who has a victim mentality. You're a grown man.
Thank you.
Stop crying like a little fucking baby.
Okay, I'll stop crying because I'm crazy. I'm just insane.
I'm just crazy, happy to help you.
And you're the reasonable one.
How are you going to succeed in life?
Grovel at your feet and kiss your toes. And then we'll talk. And then even then, you'll just use it like what Gracie does. You just rip her to shreds every day, no matter what she does.
She does not claim to be a victim. She should just fucking leave.
She should leave. It's ridiculous what goes on between you two. You're just disgusting people.
Okay, so what part of this am I supposed to respect, John?
I didn't say you have to respect any part of this. I'm just telling you because I don't respect you.
I don't respect anything you're doing now.
But I think I don't care. Really, I honestly don't really care. I just don't really like what I'm supposed to respect. That you've put me in. It sucks.
You're a victim of me.
I'm not a victim of you. You've just put me in an awful situation.
John, I don't ask anything of you.
Yeah, exactly. You don't ask anything of me. You just make me pay $550 a month to live with my two brothers who hate me because you programmed them to hate me. That's fun. I love doing that. As if this is like, now this is like the family place. This is where the whole family hangs out, right? Okay. That's good. Good. I love it. I love
you. You should be grateful to me for getting you out of your...
Thank you so much for giving me an apartment that you took away from me immediately when you gave it to me. Thank you.
John, what I don't understand is you are perfectly free to leave from all the horrible...
I'm not, Ben. You can't get an apartment when you're 18 just like that. And I have a two-year lease, or somebody has a two-year lease. You lied about the papers because you're crazy, as if that's helpful. Maybe you should just tell me what you wrote on those lease papers instead of lying to me and then making me pay half the rent every month. You withhold my renting information. I have no idea what situation I'm in. And then whenever you feel like it, you can blow up my phone and ask me to come down there whenever you feel like it and like threaten my living situation that I hate, threaten everything, ruin my life.
John, whenever you have five cats up there.
Ben, you know why I have five cats? Because you invited every piece of your family to come over, and my cat escaped because everybody leaves the fucking door open.
I didn't get my cat pregnant. You did, through the rest of your goddamn family. All of this stuff you're doing right now, you're going to have to do a 180 on. It totally fucking sucks.
Okay, thank you. You're a god. You're God.
It comes and from the bowels of hell.
My living situation
this once, is yeah. how the devil talks.
Now you're going to threaten my living situation once again. Thank you, Ben. I you hate all of the members of your
no,
family
no, no, no,
you
no.
think I everybody's against you in life. You think you're the mega victim.
Fuck off.
Everybody
Bye.
Hates you.
I'm done.
Everybody
Bye.
Hates you. Look, all Bye. Of your sons hate you. Oh, poor me. My sons hate me. That's why they love me. Oh, they hate me so much. So does my wife. Oh, so does my other daughter. Oh, you know, everybody's against me. I'm a little bitch boy. He's going to cry about it on the internet all day. Oh, poor me. Baby, you're like a baby. That's what a baby does. He cries about how his wife
out of it. It's just unbelievable.
Have wronged him his whole life. That's what he does. Little baby. Baby, baby, Ben.
Cries
about how his sons and his wife wronged him for the rest of his life because he's a quote-unquote traditional guy who's got himself together. Yeah, right, Ben.
Yes, I'm a great
You're
guy.
You're a traditional guy. That's why you...
I'm a great guy.
That's why all of your children, you don't talk to any of them.
Right.
You hate them. Because they're against you,
You won't let me talk. Why won't you let your father talk to you? Why won't you let your father talk to you?
Why
won't you let your father talk to
you?
Why won't you let your father talk to you?
Throw it in their face all the time.
Fucking burn in hell, you fucking
Your daughter
asshole.
And your sons are nice people, and you hate them.
May you rot in hell for...
What a baby. Yeah, Ben rage quitted, and so did his daughter in spirit.
John, don't you think this is exactly what mom wants, is you screaming
yes,
at dad?
Yes, because everything has to do with your dynamics between your parents. That's what your entire life should be centered around, Gracie. I'm not like you, Gracie. I don't center my entire life around the dynamics of my older parents. 20 years old, and all you do is cry about how your mommy doesn't feed you enough or something. 20 years old, you can't do anything with your life. Fucking
you
loser.
Literally just said
why don't you go find a man who will like
you
who will like
the irony?
You because I think that's
you
the only way that you will be happy in life
you.
Is if you have a guy who tells you to shut the fuck up and stop crying about your mommy all the time because that's not what everybody's like
you
about.
Literally
that's
just
what
screamed
that's what people who have no like free thinking do they just attribute everything to other people in their
are
life
you ever gonna
everything
stop?
Is your fault everything is your fault everything is your fault
are you
oh
ever
mommy everything is your
do
fault
not
I can
do
never
this.
Change
oh don't do this
okay you got me I won't do this anymore you won you're the alpha you won. Nobody can hear you. You muted yourself. Don't you think Ben has like a gay way of sitting and looking? It's just gay. I don't know how to say it. Like, you're not like the like manly looking guy here. You're like looking at your screen like a little princess. Snooty. All snooty. Got your nose turned up because you're better than this. With your gay little hat on that I bought you as a Father's Day gift because I hate you so much. Looking at your screen, looking at me, hating me.
You do die of starvation. I hope you die of starvation and I hope you are thrown out of that apartment. I do.
That's nice. Yep. Good, thank you.
I'll go to the landlord right now.
What did I do in
this
apartment?
What you've done.
Did I jerk off or something? I don't know what I did. What did I do?
You have five cats in that apartment.
I can tell my landlord that and I'll tell my landlord that you're living downstairs like a fucking weirdo smoking his fucking apartment away. That's not even an apartment. It's a commercial space, buddy.
You don't live down here. I'll be living
up
there.
Yeah, you do, buddy. Yeah, well, you live down here right now and you're smoking away.
You want to go? You want to go?
No, I don't want to go.
John, you have been unbelievably irresponsible up there, John.
How? What have I done? I don't know why
you come up there and beat the fucking shit out of you. I'm going to beat the fucking shit out of you.
Oh, my God.
I'm going to beat your fucking knee. So you'll need another surgery.
Cool guy. Cool guy. You're a cool guy,
I will.
Man.
I
yes,
will.
You're
I think
the alpha.
Twice.
You're the alpha. You know
Shut
what?
Your
if
mouth.
I die that way, then so be it. I hope you rot in hell for saying that. Because I don't know what you're saying,
Stop
but that's not a nice thing to say.
Fucking over
said,
me.
I never said I was going to physically assault you and beat your broken knee.
Yes, you should never do that to your father. But a father,
you should never do that to your son, buddy. You're not like a traditional man who's like a cool guy. And he told his son,
and we'll do it on Discord. Yeah,
you're not a cool guy, buddy.
And as I beat your fucking head,
lights the cigarettes like a faggot. No offense, but you do. Your whole like smoking thing is gay
now
too.
Now it's no offense. No offense. Oh, thank you so
much.
That's
the joke.
You're not being offensive
because you're a cringy boomer. But gay. I don't know. You're the way you like just picked at your lip is gay.
Boot this.
Yeah, boot me. This is. I really care. I really care. Thank you, Ben, for letting me talk shit about you.
You get lost.
Oh, thank you.
Unless you can behave. You want to behave?
No. I don't know what behaving means. Act like Grace.
Boot yourself.
Act like Grace. Should I act like Grace? Would that be behaving?
Yes.
Your little slave, weirdo slave girl? Because that's what she is. She's your weirdo little slave.
So you're here to talk to your dad, right? But you won't let him talk? Can you let me talk now? Okay, enough speeches.
This is a Discord call. You don't have anything else to do in your day. This does not have
to
wrap up.
I don't want to listen to your insolence. I do not.
What do you have to do all day? What are you going to do after this? Cry in your bed?
I do not want. I don't have to listen to your horse shit.
Okay. Yeah, you don't. You can
You're
boot 18 me
years
you
old.
Want. You have.
I never have to talk to you
right
again.
Now.
I never have to talk to you again. You can.
I would love that. You don't talk to me anyways.
No,
and the
go
only
ahead.
Time you
go.
Do talk to me is
go.
When you quote unquote ask
Goodbye.
For help.
Go ahead. Go ahead. Do it. Follow through. Go
okay.
ahead. Flip
oh.
off. Fuck you. Never come back. Go
okay.
move away. Fuck you.
Okay. You
Try
got
to
me,
someone
buddy.
Else. Fuck you. Fuck you.
You got me, buddy.
Go
you
ahead,
won.
Blip off, big guy.
I never said I'm going to blip off myself. You were the one
you
who said
I
never want to
talk to
you again.
Again.
I never
go
said
ahead
I was
and follow
talk
through,
to you,
you faggot.
See, this is what you. You're just such a hypocrite. You're the one who said you were going to never talk to me again. I never said that about you.
Yes, you did.
No, I just said that if
I
that
said
is the
I
way
never
was,
have to talk to you again. And you said, oh, I'd love that. So go love it.
Well, why don't you go love it?
Get lost, call a taxi, and never talk to me again.
You were the one who threatened it.
Goodbye.
Okay, buddy. You were the one who threatened it in the first place, Alpha Wolf.
Goodbye. Go cry to someone else. I don't want to hear it.
Why would an alpha guy dress like you and smoke like you? It's just gay. You're not an alpha. You're a wannabe tough guy.
I don't
want to
hear it, so
you know,
get lost.
Okay, I'll give you my psychoanalysis of you. You're a wannabe tough guy who was a little bit of a beta earlier in his life, and he figured out that was a loser
an analysis of me
so,
or anything else.
Now he's trying
Go
to be
away
a cool,
and never
tough
come back.
Guy, and I think you should just give up the act and act like a nice guy, which you are, instead of a crazed fucking irrational alpha retard, and
okay.
I think you're trying to
yeah.
cover
okay.
up something. I
okay.
don't know.
I don't think
what
I've
have
I
ever done
I don't
to
think,
you that war-
I don't think
don't
I sided with my
talking.
Mom. It's just that my mom
don't
is the
keep
only
talking.
That
Shut
can help me in a real
fat,
way. I don't
fucking
know what to tell you.
Loser, faggot, mouth sometimes.
I can't talk. You get to control how I talk because you're the
you
alpha.
Can,
okay,
oh,
I get it.
God
whenever you feel like
you.
It, you can hold
God
your hand up
damn,
and say stop talking. And they get
what
angry when I don't stop
loser.
Talking. I
what
get it. See, you're
loser.
The alpha of the world.
John.
You beat everybody. Stick
John.
Everybody here because everybody, if you gave them a chance, would disappoint you. And then you'd scream
John.
At them and ask them to apologize like you did to Daniel.
Okay, you can talk, and then I can talk. How about that for a rule?
Is you talk at me, and that's not a good thing.
John, you are bringing damnation onto your head by doing
yes,
what you're doing.
Yes, God hates me, right? God hates me. I think God loves
God
me.
God hates
I really
what you're
have
doing.
To worry about God right now.
God loves you,
life.
But God hates
yeah,
what
well,
you're
I
doing
don't think
right
I'm
now.
Condemning myself with anything
I
say. I
think
and
you are.
You're wrong. For using that against people all the time as if you're God. You're not God. You're not the prophet of God. You shouldn't use that as a way to say you're going to go to hell whenever you feel like it. I think the way you've treated me has someone
doing
condemned
evil.
You to hell in a way.
You are
you
doing evil now. Stop doing evil.
The way you've acted towards
Stop
me at least.
Doing evil. Stop it. Woman and I talk
I don't
to a man.
Talk like an angry woman. You talk
yes,
like
you
an
do.
Angry woman who's been
cucked by his wife and everybody in his life. That's what you
shouldn't do this. You should not face up like that.
That's what you act.
You are bringing damnation onto yourself by doing this. Shut up.
Don't be such a bitch.
Shut up. Shut your fat fucking faggot mouth for 1 minute.
Yes, you're acting a little hysterical right now, Ben. It's very womanly.
You're a bitch, obviously, too. If you, after this 20 minutes, you say, I'm the one who's spurging. You are a little bitch, the one who's spurging.
You always spurg because you're a baby. And you use, like, quote-unquote, etiquette of conversation as your way of spurging. And it's not...
You're so scared of me.
Right. Jeffrey Dahmer is on your side, John. All right?
Yeah.
Pursue it with him. You will find that he is not someone
Everybody's on my side.
Hey, Jeffrey Dahmer is a good guy.
He's a really good guy.
He is.
Yeah, but it's not clear that he isn't also trolling at the same time. But whatever.
I'm not trolling John. I think John is 100% right about your family.
He's the only one of you that is sane.
He doesn't need to be respectful to you.
Okay, so you don't
think there's no reason for him to respect you.
He's going
to
do the same thing.
No, sons should respect their fathers, but you haven't been a father to your son, so why should he respect you?
Right. Okay. I think a son should always respect his father, and I think that anyone who says otherwise...
Yeah, we know you think this, because you hate your own father, and you have this weird...
I do not hate my father, and I respect him, too.
I don't know how you can say anything else.
No?
Okay, you don't like him very much.
He is in the clutches of... I can't talk, though, right? I can't talk. Can we
that's
say
not how you John, talk to people? That's not how John, you talk can, to people. Okay, I'm sorry.
Okay, now you're talking. You're saying how to talk to people.
Hey, you just freak out.
Are you interested in listening to anyone other than yourself screaming?
You can talk over me if you want, and then it's mostly when you're on a Discord call because we're not in person. It's kind of hard to know the cues, so sometimes it's better to just talk over somebody until they shut up. Yes, that's how it works sometimes on a Discord call.
Sometimes that works. Sometimes you listen to other people.
Yes, but it's kind of hard to know when you start talking when it's so low.
Here's a suggestion. Why don't you shut your fucking mouth for a few minutes?
That's not very respectful to the conversation. Yeah, yelling that at somebody. I'm not a little kid anymore. You shouldn't yell that at me.
Shut your fucking mouth for a few minutes.
That's called ad hominem.
Sus.
John, are you having a good time in my Discord?
Why do you keep saying that? I can leave whenever
are
I
you?
Want.
Are you? It seems like you are. Can you just say I'm having a good time in your Discord?
You.
Okay. You're enjoying yourself. Okay. Can I make a suggestion as the person who's running this Discord that maybe you just take a little bit of a breather now? We get the message. You're angry and you're a victim of everything and everyone. I think everyone gets that. Maybe other people could say something. John, this guy who is allying himself with you is a complete and utter loser.
But I don't think that... Oh, Provo?
Not at the core, but like on the surface.
Provo?
He has said that he can't stay awake ever any day for the rest of his life. No, Snick.
Yeah, for context, Jerome, he's got like a neurological illness called
it's called I hate my father.
I don't know what
that you have, John.
He doesn't even have a neurological illness. He just sleeps all day anyways. Unfortunately. In what way are you a religious man?
Okay, be quiet. Yeah, let me tell you what I'm saying. John was on Oxycontin, right? That's an opioid. He could say to me, Dad, I became hooked on Oxycontin. And I don't know the lingo. Loser pills, okay? Loser pills.
I took them for a couple days. I have most of them saved.
A lot of people like John will say, you know, a month from now, look, I became addicted to opioids and now I'm an opioid addict. And they would say, what are you going to do about it? And I would tell him, go fuck yourself. That's what I'm going to do about it.
Hey, John.
And okay, John.
That's not really that big of a hoax.
I don't understand why he can't just go to his Discord and do what he wants.
I can ban him. You want me to ban him? That's easier.
All right, we'll ban you. That's fine. We'll ban him.
Bitches are.
What he wants to do, he doesn't want to be respectful. Do you want to make an like all these retards can go to your Discord?
Fries are busting.
In 2 seconds. Hey. So why don't you go to your Discord? I don't care.
Wow, Ben killed the fucking VC.
You right muted now. Yourself.
I'll be quiet. I'll be quiet. It's more. I just want to listen.
No, I don't want you here.
Okay. Guys, stop with the gay
Okay, he's still here. Do you want him here? I can ban him. Damn, I can kick him.
Next, we'll take a look at Ben and Grace's relationship. It was very common when the Thorps were doing voice calls with us for Ben to declare that Grace was in a crisis. In this clip, because Grace was being quote-unquote crazy, she had to be physically corrected and kicked out of the house. What Ben fails to mention is that she was banished to the studio Ben rents, which is about 15 steps away from their front door.
See, we talked for a long time yesterday about this thing with Feeny and these ladies, but she woke up this morning and went right into victim mode and was just being really, really hostile. And, you know, I spent the whole day yesterday investing in being supportive and being, you know, trying to present her with the vision that she, but in the end, she has to want to do that. And I don't want her to be sitting here kicking me in the balls.
Grace, I thought you said that's what.
Daniel, I'll tell you what it is because you were asking about this. This is what it is. There is a trauma. Something happened to her. And she wants to replay the trauma, this time as the person who's in charge. You know that routine? There's a real temptation to abuse others as a way of solving the problem. But all you do is make it worse. And you end up with massive guilt for it, right?
Yeah, I understand.
But
yeah,
it's also very tempting to do.
Mm-hmm.
You have to solve that problem is that you have to go through this trauma. It doesn't have to take a million years. And you have to like understand that in some way you were not the victim of that trauma. You
keep almost getting there, but what's actually the behavior? Because I still can't quite get my head around that.
What's the trauma?
No, the behavior. So why is Grace kicked out? Like literally, why is she kicked out?
Okay, so literally, I would say in short, sure. Literally all day yesterday, I was saying, Grace, I would like you to get some space. And we had all these people spent like a large part of their day. And I know it's somewhat entertaining, but also I think people do invest. And, you know, trying to say like, okay, Grace, there's a way in which, yes, it would be good for you to get some movement away from me. And some of them were saying the most extreme things like, you got to get out of there. You're being abused. Okay, but I was saying like, okay, but I do agree somewhat with this idea of getting some distance and not being so intertwined with me. I think it's unhealthy. Mm-hmm. So in response to that, after getting off Discord, she was extremely agitated. And I was like, okay, why don't you just go to sleep? I'll go to sleep. We'll see you in the morning. And she woke up feeling also like really, really angry. Now, this is the part that drives me to homicide. I'm trying to help her and I'm trying to be gentle. And I'm trying to say this would be good for you. And she is saying, fuck you. I want it to be unhealthy.
Right.
I want you to tell me that I'm a victim all the time.
But she's not saying like she's not saying that literally, right?
Well, so I spent 10 hours with you yesterday. So I get up and we have a thing where Grace does a nominal, you know, like in the morning she'll make some coffee, but she's like, I don't want to get up. I'm not getting enough sleep, you know, and it's just this hostility. And then it's like, okay, all right, I'll make the coffee or whatever. She made the coffee. And then I was like, you know, I was kind of hoping that she would sort of take some initiative today to say like, okay, let me get more into that. And instead she just flakes off on the phone without telling me for like 2 hours. I'm watching TV, watching some, you know, stuff that I'm doing like Catholic stuff on YouTube. And she's just acting totally antisocial. And then I'm like, what are you doing? And she's like, well, and acting all autistic. And it's like, I just got furious because I'm like, what are you doing? You're not going to communicate now? You're punishing me? This is what I find infuriating. You're punishing me for spending the whole day yesterday trying to get you. This was the problem with her mother, too. I said, like, this relationship is too intense. If you know what you're supposed to be doing, then you should do it. It's not about me yelling at you. But she always made it maximally chaotic so that every conversation had to be about, like, what the fuck is going on here? Place out in here. I got us a studio, a storage area. I was building the infrastructure. And so it was sabotaged by her and her mother. It just was. It was like, nope, I want you at fucking gunpoint structure. And she says, I want chaos so that I can feel like a victim. And what do you do? I always say, like, I think my sense of reason should rule things and your emotions should go in the back door or garbage can. And so it's just this war. Like, I don't fucking care about your fucking emotions. She says, I don't know. I'm not feeling inspired. But when I tell her, why don't you do this? She gets angry at me. And I think that's because there's a basic irrationality, an addiction to chaos. Because when it's chaotic, she can claim to be a victim. Now, does she really want to do that? No, but she's addicted to abusing me.
I do think that's, I don't know.
I told her this morning sincerely that I wanted to kill her and I wanted to punch my fist through her fucking face, through her fucking stupid brain and out the back of her skull. Nice. Instead of leaving, she stayed and got really physically close to me while claiming, right? What the fuck is wrong with someone who does that? They don't care about living or dying. All they care about is maximizing the chaos that they're creating for you. I meant it, and she knows I meant it. She knows I meant what I was saying. I want to finish my thing about going up there, punching his fucking knee so many times that the bottom half of his faggot fucking leg starts becoming unattached from the top part, ripping it off his body and throwing down to the wall.
Hey, that's my friend.
I loved it if you recorded it and actually took me to court and I had to show up in court and then have it played for the judge. And I'd say, Judge, I stand behind every word of that. The thing I regret, I do not regret damning his soul to hell or telling him I'm going to beat the shit out of him. That's my only regret, is I didn't get to finish it. New idea for Grace so that I don't end up killing her like I wanted to this morning. She can do her project that she wants to do of manipulating guys. But she wants to spend the whole rest of her life saying how hard it is to like deal with me. And, you know, I think that's kind of loserish at a certain point. You know what I mean? Like, it's been 5 years of saying, like, it's hard to get along with you. And I do understand that if you keep doing that with someone like me, like, it you know what I mean? It can be this kind of endlessly fascinating loop of driving someone to want to kill you and then acting like a victim and then apologize. It's stupid, though, isn't it? I mean, you're going to spend your whole life doing that? Like, semi-hostile with people, like, manipulating them, like... Maybe I'm going to give it away, but like, cause it's not worth even trying, but like her and a bunch of women could get this fucking faggot loser Daniel to cam up, right? By like manipulating him into saying like, actually you're really handsome, which is a lie of course, or whatever. Right. But I'm just saying lady. And I think she would be a great friend of Grace's. But what I want to do, Sonny, is have the women, you know how they do this, you don't really do it with me, this like Mac Daddy kind of thing. Cause I know you're with Unbleached. So I don't do that with you, but they all do this thing with me about like, I'm not going to suck your big dick. You know, this guy Feeney, who's been on my show, and Grace has a chance to manipulate him, you know, sexually without
is that bald dude, that fat bald dude who come on?
No, that's Phil.
The What's problem
Feeney?
With
Feeney is bald too, though. Feeney is pretty much bald.
The problem with Feeney is every time I look at him with his little chicken hair, I want to laugh. Like I have to, you know, stop laughing every time I see him.
Yeah, you have to stop laughing and be serious about what you want to do because this could launch you into the stratosphere. You'd be doing news shows. You could be on Tucker Carlson I don't know about Tucker. Someone would interview you about it because it's a fascinating story. You could do a Netflix series on it.
So
you can do there right now. The whole thing's like in hiatus. It's just sitting there. There's no reason we shouldn't act, But I was like, well, before I do this, I want to take some, you know, I just want to be making sure that I'm not doing it for the wrong motivations. And also I needed a way to make it pop because, you know, until I had a YouTube channel, who am I going to go to, right? Unless, you know, I went to newspapers, but they won't go with it until it breaks as a story, which I could have done by filing charges because then they can report on it. You know what I mean?
Thanks, bro.
Yeah, I don't believe in any of that stuff. Yeah. Well, I was just saying that Grace should sexually manipulate Feeny to come on the thing. And if she can't regulate herself with him, because this is a person we know in real life, and he seduces her, I would just laugh at her and say, like, give me a break. You're not a victim. If you have sex with John Feeney and get pregnant by him, I would laugh at you. And, you know, I just, like, whatever. So, you can't so handle you it.
So she likes John Feeney?
No.
What? Yo, boy, are you saying she's scared of being manipulated and seduced by John Feeney? Is that what you're saying? What?
I think she pretends that... Yeah, I mean, when she told me the Grossly thing, she looked at me and was like, I'm really embarrassed by what happened. And I was like, that is so ridiculous. You're such a loser. But, well, she does things like leave the stream in the middle of the stream, and then you guys start talking about, like, how you're denying the Holocaust. And then, of course, she can act like a victim of YouTube. But, I mean, you can't leave your stream and hope it works out. Yeah, she could, but I think the problem is she doesn't want to succeed on YouTube. She wants to fail on YouTube and blame me, and then, you know, that's what she wants to do more than to do something else in life. So that's why I have to keep them off of me. Grace, too.
No. Well,
with me. They're addicted to abusing me.
Next, we have the Day of Assaults. Ben has been bullied relentlessly by his son, John, for forcing his family to do YouTube content and hash their family issues on stream. This call was done to get Courtney to do a stream, where she would explain to everyone that in actuality, her and Ben were never married, and therefore she deserves nothing in their ongoing divorce, or as Ben likes to say, annulment. Even though Ben impregnated and had 6 children with this woman, actually, they were never really married.
Do you want to do a stream about it, or are you a victim of that too?
I do. I want to do a stream about it because I feel like that's like the best thing that can come out of this is content at this point.
Okay, so you're doing this as a like, kind of like act of art. You don't care what the answer to that question is?
Well, I'm saying that like this is what we talked about yesterday. That like at least we could get, even if things aren't moving or not moving quickly, is content. Like if you're, we don't want to sit around like talking to me privately. Like I thought I was.
Okay. All right. Okay. Please. It's just so crazy. I'm asking you what I think that whole thing shows what the problem is. No?
Sure. Yeah.
I don't know why you have to say, well, it'll make good content. I think I don't understand why you would say that. I don't understand that, but I guess it doesn't matter. Right?
Because I thought that was the idea that like we weren't, because things weren't working in the family.
Yeah, you're acting crazy. You're talking crazy. What is your problem? Face like a crazy now. Okay. Thing of working with the boys and getting them back on. And I think there are different options. I don't know. Grace kind of wanted to get them on a Discord today and, you know, get them more in the mix.
Yeah. I'm sick of them saying, like, I think they should engage. But, you know, they're going to play this game of saying, oh, I don't get your texts. I don't, whatever. I'm really sick of it.
As that stream about annulment goes, I think it should be you that want to do this, not me, right? Doesn't it make sense that
well,
you...
This is-
Maybe you should threaten their living situation. That'll get them on. Well, it would. If you want to get them on, you can threaten their living situation.
Who is them? I don't even know what you're talking
Charlie about. Charlie and Tommy. Like, if they don't respond to your texts and stuff.
This is a contribution.
Uh-huh. How long did it take you to think that one up?
I mean, that's what you do normally, so...
If
I
you
mean,
want to say nasty things...
That's a good idea,
side
right?
Side chat is the place for that. Side chat, you can say nasty things. Otherwise, shut up.
That's the right place for your bitchy little comments.
All right, now... What is the question?
Okay, but isn't this a problem because the stream is about how she doesn't want to do something that she should want to do. So now you're saying she should want to do the stream about how she wants to do something that doesn't want to do it, right? Like, isn't this the problem?
Well, okay, so I think we left off with me saying, it's sort of academic, but shouldn't this be your stream, Courtney, that you want to do and that I can help you with? But I don't understand. How is it my stream that I want to do?
It should be a stream that I want to do. I can have it on my channel. I don't think I could. I think I would need somebody to, like, whether it's John or, like, the guys, Provo, to, like, talk about this. You could pop in.
I don't know what you're talking about. What is it? Provo to what? Co-host?
To be a part of the discussion.
I don't know what that means. I would need them in order to stream? Why?
You're confusing him too much. Stop with the drivel.
John, on the side chat, I love the stuff you're doing. It's hilarious, buddy.
Thanks, Daddy.
The whole knee surgery meme is just so great. I've seen that 500 times now, but 500 more would really make it funny.
I'm just going to keep posting until you go crazy.
It's not even funny.
I know. It's not.
Okay.
It is not funny. I don't find it funny.
Okay. So, I don't know. What is the point?
I mean, I do find it funny.
Why don't you just say random things?
Yeah, exactly.
Okay. I don't know.
I do.
You claim to be an artist, so just random, anything random.
Yep. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's how, yep. Yeah, yep. That's how you win.
All right. Well, keep winning.
Thank you.
John.
I love your affirmation.
John, your father is constantly saying that you're doing this to protect me. Now, I cannot not allowed to agree with him about that. But I'm just telling you.
That feeling
that is totally crazy when you do what you just did there.
It's not crazy because
you're not allowed.
Yeah, okay, well, I know. That's Courtney, too crazy.
Courtney, do you know that feeling when knee surgery is tomorrow?
Yeah, I do. Awful.
Jerome, you put something in the general about something mom said that, like, she thought you were being too nice to her or something, so she
cut off.
Well,
she literally told me in this call that she thought I was being too
grateful. Before you get into it, I'm not
trying
to...
She thought I was being too grateful to her.
Wait.
She didn't want to have a relationship with
me,
quote-unquote, nice to each other. So I started being cold to you.
He's never going to let you talk, Grace. He's never going to let you talk. It doesn't matter.
The point was not... I understand you could talk about it. My point was, if you have a problem with her, she's much more likely to respond in public because privately she doesn't care because it's not recorded. My point is, if you have a problem with her, like, I think your thing, one of your things is that I think I'm a huge victim of her, but actually she's much worse to you. Okay, that could make an interesting stream or something like that. I was just going to suggest.
I don't really think it's that. I mean, it's
no
more
great. He's going to act like a victim of that suggestion. Do not suggest anything.
You're going
to
act like a victim of that.
He's a victim of every suggestion anyone makes to him.
Hell,
well, if you have, I'm just saying, if you have a beef with her,
somebody needs to call the police on you again.
Yeah, that's
I think that would sort it out. The police calling really puts you in.
It is also a crime to call the police when you have no warrant to.
That's true.
Ask Jussie Smollett. You're going to pull a Jussie Smollett. Go do it. Call him right now. Call them right now. Call the police right now. I think somebody should file charges against you, and they could drag you away on your faggot little crutches. Thank you, where you belong.
Okay. Okay, I think somebody should find something on you and then call the police.
Done.
Last time, obviously, that had a very profound effect on your life.
The more fucked I am, okay?
Yeah, it did have a profound effect.
The more fucked she is, the more fucked she is.
It does have a profound effect on my life.
She's going to say that. The more fucked she is, the more fucked I am. The more fucked I am.
Yeah, it's true.
The more fucked I am, the more fucked I am.
Yeah, it's true. That's true.
It is true.
Isn't it?
Cool
the
phrase.
More fucked I am is true.
Repeat it. Then put it in chat 500 times.
The more fucked I am.
Cool, dude. You're winning. W. Big W. Big win.
Because, the more fucked I am.
Just keep repeating it like a retard. Until
the little padded truck,
repeating it for the rest of your life. And then you'll be a victim.
And then I'll be a victim. And then I'll be a victim.
John, I have set you up against your father. So
the more fucked I am, and then I'll be a victim.
Your father, the worse it is for me and you and everybody.
The more fucked I am.
I appreciate the fact that you come up
and
against
now I'm a victim.
I'm just saying, what is he? Okay, I can't even defend him. I'm just saying, you shouldn't do this, and I can't even say that to you. I can't say it
Daddy,
to you.
You're funny. The more fucked, okay. And now you're being a victim.
Yeah, I'm being a victim.
And now you're being a victim.
Yeah. So why don't you just choose which one you're going to go
with? The
more
fucked I am, and now you're being a victim.
Which? John, just who is it? Who do you
want? John,
who is it? Who you yourself with? Me or
who
him?
Who do you align yourself with? The more fucked I am. Now you're being a victim.
Seriously, this is the level of communication.
He understands what I'm saying.
Oh, yes, I do. I understand what you're saying.
You do. That's what you're
fucked
saying.
I am. That's what you're saying.
You understand what I'm saying, and that's your whole problem with your father.
I understand what you're saying, and that's the whole problem with your father.
And my point was that if we get an annulment and a divorce, and we finish like and all the financials like kind of clear up and it's separate, then he doesn't have to like lose money from me anymore.
The but less then, fucked you are.
Jesus Christ.
But you're gonna leave and then you're gonna leave me with this fucking maniac over here who wants to threaten me and call the police on me, and I can't get rid of him because he's gonna threaten me. All right, John, I'll fucking come up there and kill you. Okay, so call the police now.
Well, I mean, that is a viable reason to call the police.
So call the police. Go ahead.
I will.
Okay.
We'll it's ringing the right thing. Now.
Go ahead. Call the police.
Okay. So Courtney is going to do a stream?
I don't know. I mean, I'm happy to. That's between you and your mother. I mean, that's your mother's decision. I don't know. She want to watch a video or talk about a video, or is she just passive? Just wants to maximize victimhood and make it crazy.
Well, I mean, it is her stream. She should probably take.
She's maximizing victimhood right now.
John, are you serious or not serious when you say that?
I'm on Dad's side about this.
Okay. All right, so I would say that why don't you come on stream with me and talk about what happened between...
Who's you? Who's you? There are a whole bunch of people here.
John.
You.
No, I'm you.
Oh, the more fucked I am. What? I'm not coming on your YouTube channel.
Okay. Well, okay. I just think...
I literally don't understand what we're talking about.
You know, Courtney, if you, why do you say, why don't you? Why when you say, could you? That's how people ask other people to do something.
Hey, she doesn't have to be nice to me. I don't care.
That's not called being nice to someone. That's called.
I don't care if she uses general.
Creating
etiquette.
A sentence that makes sense.
I don't care if she uses generalized etiquette of forming sentences or whatever. I don't care. She can do whatever she wants. She's a person, I guess.
You do, and I do.
I don't care. She
you don't care if she speaks English or just
no. I don't care if she wants. If she
you don't care about anything, right? You don't care. You don't care about anything. You do obviously do care.
I don't care if she's
stupid. Stop saying that.
Gathering.
Do you care if she shows up to take you to your therapy appointment tomorrow, or you don't care?
What?
Do you care whether she takes you to your therapy appointment tomorrow, or don't you care about that?
I care.
Okay.
But I'm saying I don't care about her grammar. Like, if she just starts talking total gibberish, I don't care.
Well, I don't know what that means, but, like, so...
Like, she can do that if she wants.
Tell her what time the appointment is, and then she forgets it language. Because she doesn't know how to use the English language, then you care. I just don't... Like, this whole thing, I don't care.
I just don't care.
See, Jerome, the subtext here is that as petty as Ben is, you have to be on his side all the time, or he's going to hold your medical health over. Just
yeah, exactly. Program.
You have to agree.
You need to be able to communicate with your mother if you're going to have her in any way in your life. If you say that doesn't make any... I don't know. Okay, whatever.
John, the last couple of weeks, your father's contention is that I'm completely crazy.
No, do you think that, please don't speak on my behalf. Please do not speak on my behalf.
But you said that yesterday.
Can say my construal of it is that. God. But I don't tell anyone what I said about anything ever again.
Okay, my construal of what your father is saying to me is that completely crazy. That is my construal of what your father is saying to me.
But I would say that in the conversation that I had with you yesterday, Courtney, that you did understand some things that I was saying, and there was some understanding sandwiched between massive insanity. By which I mean something way, way off before it, and then massive insanity that followed it. But I do think you did come to some understanding. Otherwise, why would I deal with you? For content? That's your new take. I'm milking
take.
You for content, and that's all you are now. That's your new take. I get it. That's your new take.
That's not my new take. I didn't say that.
It is your new take.
I mean, that is what you're doing.
My understanding was that...
Oh, you're a victim? John, you're a victim of that.
I mean, that doesn't necessarily have a negative connotation. It's just that is what you're doing, technically.
That I'm exclusively having a relationship.
You are milking people.
Okay, I can't finish my sentence. I can't finish my sentence.
You are literally milking people.
I can't ever finish a sentence. I can't finish a sentence?
No.
Okay. Then I'll mute myself again, and you can go fuck yourself.
I'll go fuck myself. Maybe I will.
Jerome,
my understanding,
John, you ruin the conversation every time you do this. Do you not realize that? So fucking annoying. If you have a problem with mom, I think you should do it publicly instead of having this private little thing with her, because I don't think she's going to respond unless
that's not milking for content.
Okay, but here's the thing.
I don't know what that means.
You don't know what the words mean. I don't know what that means. You don't know what that means? Do you not know what that formation of a sentence means? Milking for content.
I literally don't know how I'm supposed to talk. Every single time I start talking, you interrupt me.
Well, you don't know what that means. So let's clue you in on what milking for content means.
I spent 10 hours talking with her yesterday. I didn't get any content out of that. So I don't know what you're talking about.
I never said you only milk for content. I just said you do milk for content.
No, I will agree. I plan to milk her exclusively for my content. I don't want to have any relationship with her outside of that.
When I say that, it's but not okay. Okay.
It's important to get this financial thing, all that stuff figured out, which is the annulment thing. And I think she's going to be held more accountable to that publicly than she is on this private thing because, you know, there's no record of it. So that's the reason, okay?
But that's what I said.
I just stated the fact. You're milking people for content. I just stated that. I never said you're bad people for doing that. You did. You took it as that. I said, you milk people for content, which is true.
Yes. I am milking her. She is my lol cow, and that's all she ever will be. Yes, that's true of me. I don't know about anybody else.
Okay, so don't take it offensively when somebody tells you that. If it's true.
We've now seen Ben threaten to beat his son and also use police in order to take him out of the picture. Given that Ben and Grace are attached at the incest hip and work together on their schemes, what happens next is a shock, but in hindsight is a logical outcome, given all the threats Ben has made as a recourse to his son bullying him on Discord calls.
Because I said, let's do it on YouTube, and you're angry about that I made you do that. I'm just saying it doesn't make any sense.
What was it really?
If you think that you are speaking the truth, physically assaulted me. We'll call the police.
Yeah, I'm going to. I have it all on video. I'm going to call the police right now.
Well, your son's going to go to jail now.
What happened?
He attacked Grace physically.
I have it on video.
I would say, can we just calm it down?
Because you don't want to do anything.
Does she have to? Does she have to call the police?
Right, hold on, Grace.
Can he come online?
He said to me. He said. I was talking to Tom. He said, "Hey, Tom, if you're nicer to her, maybe she'll suck you off." And then I said, "John, that's not okay to say." And I started recording. And then he physically assaulted me. He hit me in the face with his cane, with his crutch.
Okay. But before we call the police,
Need to call the police.
I got hit in the face with a crutch. I mean,
okay.
And I obviously, have video.
Obviously, he shouldn't have done that.
Go to the police for that.
Yeah, why not?
Why not? No,
because, okay, because.
Why shouldn't he? He has no right to do that to me.
That's true. But maybe he can apologize, like right now. I told him
I'm going to call the police if you keep doing this.
Okay, he lost control. You know he has a temper. I know it wasn't right for him to do, and I'm really sorry that it happened. But like
Why don't you bring him on now?
Why don't you bring him on now, or else I'm calling the fucking police?
Sure.
He's got 5 fucking minutes. I'm not doing this shit anymore. I am on the lease to that apartment. I am allowed to be up there. He has no right. He has no right to physically assault me.
Okay, you're screaming.
I agree. I just heard about what happened, and Grace is going to call the police. If you don't, just come on.
So what's the idea?
Just give me one more minute. Let me just try one more thing.
Can you go away?
Yeah.
You're not hurt.
I'm hurt. I was physically hurt. Yeah.
Well, I mean.
My chin burns.
It's illegal what he did. He's an adult.
Zero wrong. He committed several crimes. He tried to forcefully eject me from a lease that I'm on the lease. My name is on there.
Well, he can do what he wants. If he wants to be a man and come on stream and work it out, that's fine. But if he wants to double down on that.
He choked me.
It'll be on his permanent record. Destroy his prospects for the rest of his life, but he doesn't care.
Hey, can you just put this on speaker? Because John won't talk to me. Because Grace is going to call the police on him for hitting her with his crutch.
Well, let's watch the footage, Grace.
And if he doesn't come online And at least, like,
once it destroys his life, you can do that.
She's going to call the police, and I really don't want that. I would like him to. I would like him to come online, so I would like to be able to talk to him.
Right. He doesn't learn.
You want to be an idiot? Go ahead.
Okay, can he hear me? Oh, can John hear me? John, Grace is going to call the police and you will be arrested for assault. Okay? This is real. This is what's going to happen. So you should come online and work it out. It doesn't have to go down like this, but it will. I guarantee you it will. And you won't be the victim of it because you shouldn't have hit her. So just come online and we can work it out. Don't amp it up anymore. It can be fixed.
Show the video, Grace. Watch it on stream. Tell them to watch it on stream.
We're going to play the video on stream. I mean, I know that you're like super angry and you feel like, why don't you
side with you? Side with him.
I'm not siding with him. I'm just saying that I understand the position he's in. Attacked
your daughter physically.
I'm not siding with him.
She didn't do anything.
I know she didn't do anything, but like, I'm just saying.
Why are you taking his side?
I'm not taking his side. He needs to make decisions in life. John, I know you don't want to do it, but you should.
Never tell him the truth, yeah? Never tell him the truth.
I am telling him the truth. I'm saying he should come online. He should make it right. I understand that. I don't understand that he's angry, but I do know that he's angry. Adult.
If he doesn't want to do what's right, it's not your job to. You can wreck his
John,
life.
I'm just kind of begging you at this point. Please come online. I really think that it would be the best thing. It's not to embarrass you. It's just to work it out. I guarantee you, trust me on this one. I know you don't trust me, but it is the best thing you can do. I really don't want you to get, I don't want the police to come there. I don't want a report filed. It's going to be on your record. I don't want any of that. It doesn't have to happen. Can you hear me, Tom? Tell Tommy, tell him that Ron's going to be brought into it.
No, I don't know what you're talking about.
Well, maybe that would motivate him to resolve this.
No, I don't want my landlord being brought into this.
Oh, I thought that you were saying that you were going to call him.
Okay, but you shouldn't say things that you don't know what you're doing. He's not here. Okay, so we can call the police. There's nothing stopping us.
Just give me one more second. Can we just, look, can we give it like just a few more minutes? Like, can we give it a half an hour? Let him cool down. He can cool down.
It is up to Grace.
Okay, well, I'm asking Grace.
She was assaulted. She was assaulted, far as I know.
Okay, I understand that. I believe her.
So she has a right as an adult who was assaulted to do as she pleases.
Okay, I'm asking.
Talk with her about why she
should do this? I do want to talk to her about why she should wait.
Can you hear this if I play it?
About how you're a fag? Yeah, that's pretty good, huh?
Can you hear that, Mom?
Yes, I can hear it.
Okay.
What's your problem? Fucking faggot.
Hey, Tommy, if your dice turn up, maybe she'll suck you off.
What's that? That's kind of vile, honestly.
Yeah, it is. It's disgusting.
No, but the words are vile.
What'd you say?
Oh no, it's kind of bad.
What's going on? Tom says something to me and you say I'm gonna suck him off?
Nope, that's not what I said, idiot.
That is what you said.
No, it's not.
You said, Tom, if you're nice enough to her, maybe she'll suck you off. You didn't say that?
Nope, I didn't.
I don't have it on video?
Oh my God.
I have it, so you're lying. I have it.
Yeah.
So you're a liar? And you're disgusting?
I'll pull up the video.
Yeah, I will. I will. I'll have fun showing everybody the kind of things you say to me and my brother. Yes, I will.
Hey, Gracie.
You're really
What are you doing?
You're really
I'll enjoy
Get
it.
Get out of my apartment.
Get out of my fucking apartment, bitch.
Oh,
get
oh,
out of my apartment.
Now I have physical assault.
You're not allowed
in here. I have physical assault
on
video.
Whatever you want to.
I have physical assault on video. I have physical assault on video.
Oh, my God. Okay, cool.
I have physical assault on video.
Do you think this is winning?
This is not your apartment. I'm allowed up here. I'm on the lease.
Get out of here, Grace.
I am on the lease.
You're not allowed to be up here.
I am on the lease. You physically assaulted me, and I'm on the lease.
Get out of here.
Oh, now you choked me. You just choked me. Did he just choke me?
Get out. W, you're winning. You're winning. Get out. You're winning. W. Look at him. Look at who cool guy. W, you're winning.
You choked me. I'm on the lease. So you are physically assaulting me when I'm on the lease to be up here in this apartment.
You're winning.
Is that what you just did?
You won. You're winning.
I'm going to turn this into the police,
okay.
And that's what we're going to do. You physically assault
physically
me one
assault.
More time, and I will call the police.
Physically assault.
Yes.
Fuck you. Get out. Fuck off, bitch. Oh, fucking slob. And you go make food and then not clean it up again.
You are going to be evicted for that, and I'm going to press charges against you.
You are?
Yes.
You are?
What are you gonna do?
Fucking asshole! Fuck you! You deserve that so much! Fucking slob!
Now that's
Hope
on video
you go
too.
To fucking hell, Grace.
That's on video too. It's all on video.
Go to hell!
That's
Stop
all
harassing
on video.
Me!
I have the right
Stop
to
it.
Be up here.
This is not your place! I'm allowed to be up here!
I'm on
Get
the lease!
Get the fuck off of my ass!
I am on the lease.
Get
you,
away!
You and
leave.
Go in the room and shut the door. You said an insult to me and my brother.
Yeah,
I have the right to record
it,
and you do not have the right to physically assault me.
You deserved it, weirdo.
You have physically assaulted me four
physically
times.
I want to physically assault you again.
Okay,
and
good.
And I will, maybe, if
good.
I want to.
Good, I have it all on video. Good.
Yes.
Good.
Good.
I'm not leaving because I'm allowed to be on the lease.
Oh, I've hurt you so bad.
I'm allowed to be on the lease. I have it on tape.
Then sleep in here. You lied to the landlord. So if you want
to, that's not true.
Well, these guys aren't
I'm
supposed
on the
to
lease.
Be here. These guys aren't supposed to be up
I
here.
I am on the lease.
That's not true. These guys aren't supposed
I
to
am
sleep
on the
in
lease.
Here. They're not on the lease.
You physically assaulted me for being in an apartment which I'm on the lease
these
on.
These guys aren't on
that
the lease.
That is a prosecutable charge.
You're winning. This is what winners do.
Yeah, it is.
Okay, Karen.
And I'm going to continue recording you until you go into your bedroom and lock the door.
No, because this is not your apartment.
I am on the lease. You want to bring it up legally? I'm on the lease.
I don't want to bring it up legally.
You cannot eject me from my own from
yes,
an apartment
here,
that
guys.
I am on the lease on.
Get out of here.
Nope.
These guys aren't on the lease. They're not supposed to be living up here.
That's not what we're talking about. They're allowed to be up here.
No, they're not.
Yes, they are.
Well, you're not sleeping up here. You're sleeping where you're not supposed to sleep. So if you want to talk about, like, legal stuff, which you keep bringing up, we can talk about that all day.
Sure.
You're wrong.
Sure. You have no proof of anything. I have proof of you physically assaulting me.
Okay. You're winning.
I'm not going to stop
winning. You're winning.
Recording
okay.
until
cool.
you
great,
go in your
content,
room.
Content, Grace. Nobody thinks you're cool or funny.
I don't care. You broke the law. You just broke the law.
I did. Why?
You physically assaulted me and you tried to
physically
eject me from an apartment
again.
That I'm on the
okay,
lease
Grace,
of.
You want to talk about that? You want to do this?
You want to keep
wanna
doing
do
it?
Fuck off! Fuck off! Fucking cunt. I hope I broke it back there. Fuck off.
I say call the police. I don't see any need to. He wants to do this with his life, then that's. Are you calling the police?
Hey, just wait, Grace. Just wait. Just wait. Like, last time it was good that we waited. And it was just wait.
He called the police on Dad for no reason. I'm not allowed to call the police on him.
You are allowed to call the police. I'm not saying you're not. I'm just saying, can we just slow it down? And maybe just, like, so I'm not saying that, like, you can't do it in a half an hour. I'm just saying, like, a little bit of time, a little bit of time just to sort it out. And then we can just go from there. Just, like, a little time for John to calm down. I'm not saying he has any right to time or anything. But I don't want this to happen. And I, whether people, whether John is wrong or right, I don't want it to happen. And so
I was making some food up there. I want him out of that apartment now.
Okay. So you won't call the police? I mean, where do you want him to go? He's like, you just
want him to go to jail.
All the logic, Grace, like it's
I have the right to be up there. Why do I not have the right to be up there? I was making some food.
He needs to apologize.
Yes, he needs to apologize. He needs to
apologize. And
he's in the chat.
She still has the right to.
He's in the chat. He's not going to come on.
I just think that if he could just, I think that you know that he gets a little like.
You send
the stream. Making excuses.
You send the stream. Right,
he's saying it's funny. He's saying that's funny.
You send the stream.
Call the fucking police.
All right, I'm calling.
All the logic, Grace. Like it's.
I have the right to be up there. Why do I not have the right to be up there? I was making some food.
He needs to apologize.
Yes, absolutely. He needs to apologize. He needs to
apologize. And
he's in the chat.
She still has the right to.
He's in the chat. He's not going to come on.
I just think that if he could just. I think that you know that he gets a little like
you send the
not making excuses.
You send the stream.
Right, he's saying it's funny. He's saying that's funny.
You send the stream.
Call the fucking police.
All right, I'm calling them.
John, please come up.
He's saying it's funny to assault somebody.
This isn't a joke. The police are coming. It's not funny. Just come up on stream. Like this is like you have to understand, John. Like some of it's real, right?
It's too late.
Some of it's like a little bit different. John, just come on stream. This is so ridiculous. Just come on stream.
Well, this is what he's been doing now for years, so you can see how funny it is.
John, you're like, I know you're like on this roll and you're saying like vindication, nothing's going to happen. Like this is like.
It doesn't matter. It's not in your hands anymore.
She's calling him, John. You fucked up. Fucked up, John.
Out of control.
They're
person.
On their way.
Totally out of control, person. Never going to be any consequences.
Charlie and Tommy should, well, whatever, they can be up there.
They're witnesses.
Yeah. Grace calls the police on family. He called the, well, it doesn't matter.
She's every right to call the police. Do you want to take? You want to talk? I don't know.
Well, okay. So
nothing to say.
The police are coming. Like, but it just it still doesn't have to be. It still doesn't have to be this. John still has time. He can apologize to Grace, and Grace can say, "I'm not pressing charges." That's what can happen at this point. So
why?
John, you still
haven't just. Why doesn't he just? Why does he do this? Why did he choose to do that?
He did that because he's protecting me and he shouldn't have done it. He shouldn't protect me.
You're not right, but you're the one doing this or whatever, but he's responsible for his own actions, but you don't care, right? You're the victim because he's the victim and that's what you're going to do.
They're not going to take any kids away. He's an adult.
Grace, it's YouTube chat. Jesus Christ.
I'm doing everything I can at this moment to try to get John and Grace to a place.
Well, do you think you might be motivated now to do something instead of doing what you're doing?
Yes.
Well, I don't really know what to tell you. I'm not going to live stream the police.
Okay.
I don't know what you're going to do. John has now had plenty of time to John, do the right thing, and he chose not to.
John, you still have
a funny joke.
It's not funny, John. Like, it's not. You can come on stream, talk to Grace. I think you should apologize. I know you should apologize before the police get here.
It's falling on empty ears. We decided to keep doubling down on bad behavior until it ended in violence. And I don't know what to tell you.
John, don't listen to the chat. Like, they're not, like, they're not, like, looking out for your best
interest. The police are here, dummy.
Don't listen to the chat, John. It's not like,
oh, Courtney. What are you talking about?
I'm saying John is probably saying, oh, like, this is funny. It's not funny.
He's dealing with a police officer right now. He's not watching the stream.
Okay.
It's over. That's right. Over. I don't know what to tell you.
John, don't listen to the chat. Like, they're not, like, they're not, like, looking out for your best
interest. The police are here, dummy.
Don't listen to the chat, John. It's not like,
oh, Courtney. What are you talking about?
I'm saying John is probably saying, oh, like, this is funny. It's not funny.
He's dealing with a police officer right now. He's not watching the stream.
Okay.
It's over. That's all right. Over.
All right. All right. Well,
I'm going to go see what's going on. Okay. So you take the stream. Do not stop the stream. Great content. Okay.
All right. All right. Okay, so this whole family is a huge mess, and I'm supposed to tell the truth. And the truth is that I caused that problem between John and Grace. They used to be really good. You know, they loved each other, brother and sister. Like, they were, like, very tight. And because of what I did to this whole family, that's why this is going on.
Well, they took him. So he needs to be bailed out. But I don't really think he should be bailed out until he apologizes. I don't really understand what the thinking is here, but I guess that's where craziness goes. You're the victim now?
I'm not the victim. I'm just thinking about, like, what to do. Like, does he have a phone on him? Can he, like, contact us?
Well, why should we care what happens to him? He's an adult. He's the person who got himself in jail. Didn't he? He thinks it's funny? Fuck him.
So did the cop say anything about how long he's going to be in there for and how, you know?
No, you're not going to do this to me now. I went and talked with Ron because, you know, I didn't want him getting alarmed. So, whatever. I mean, Ron said it's like, but I'm not paying for no lawyer. He's going to have a bunch of hearings and shit. I think it's good. Yeah, you know, everyone thinks it's funny when someone has these issues. I don't think it's funny. You think it's an opportunity to keep doing what you're doing. I think it's good that, you know, reality hits. And I think you should be taken off to jail too. But, you know, your crimes are ones that are not punishable.
I mean, I do agree. Like, I think if anybody should be in jail, it's me right now. But like, he took the hit for me. Right? But I don't. How can I fix this?
This is how lies. You know, you just think it's fun. Like, it's, well, whatever. He's just being like patricidal in his sort of conversations with me. But whatever, right? Whatever. He's a great kid.
But so what am I supposed to say to him? I don't know what you're supposed to say to him. He's being patricidal. I can't tell him, like, John, you can't say this.
For years, and you will not solve the problem because you don't want to tell the truth to your mother, and you don't think there are going to be consequences. Well, here are some consequences. Your son is in jail.
Okay, but I want to tell the truth to my mom.
You had an opportunity on Discord to tell the truth. You had an opportunity yesterday to tell the truth. Instead, you decided to make it about how you're a victim. And he, right? It meshes right with your victim energy. You get tired of it. You get tired of telling the truth. And you prefer to live in a fantasy world, which causes massive damage, which is now has your son in jail. Why do you care? You obviously don't care. You've seen your kids' lives destroyed for the last 5 years. You don't care about that. You're not going to care about this. There's no such thing as a wake-up call for you. Unless I don't know.
Well, I'm just going to keep saying
it. The hysterical reaction is you've done this before. And then it just becomes more bullshit.
But this is because I can't. Okay.
This is going to be different. You know, whatever.
All right. What's up?
All right, Courtney, how's it going? Happy New Year.
Thanks, you too. How's it going? I don't know. Like, I feel like I'm getting somewhere by just talking this out and saying, like, I do want this to be over. Like, I don't want this lie, like, that, like, I was married and, like, Ben hurt me or anything just to keep going.
What's this shit about you never being married? You have to explain it to me, and not in a kind of vague way. Just tell me how it is.
Okay, well, like, in the Catholic Church, like, in order to be married, it's not like a ceremony, like, so much as it is, like, taking marital vows, right? And those vows are, like, that you intend to have children. That was an intention, so, like, that doesn't check the box. That you intend to be, to never, like, you know, to be monogamous. That was an intention. But, like, that you also intend to, like, be their support and be like just to support your husband, which I wanted to do, but I was never able to do. I could never do that. And I know that I could never do that. So I want, when I took my vows, like I was saying, I really hope I can do this. I really want to do this, but I couldn't do it.
But then you said I want to. So isn't that good enough?
It's not good enough. You can't just want to, you have to be able to do it. Like, in other words, you can't, like, go onto a football, like, team and say, like, I want to be a good player. Like, you have to be a good player.
But intentions must mean something, surely.
No.
No, actually, they don't. Intentions don't mean anything.
You can't go, okay, to use the analogy again, you cannot go into a football team and say, I have every intention of being a great player. It means nothing. You can either play or you cannot play, right?
And so he's saying that you knew this from the start, that you were never going to support him, and you lied.
He said I lied, but like he's not saying like it was a malicious. I'm pretty sure he's not saying it was a malicious lie, or that even I knew it at the time. I just know that like after everything that's happened, looking back on that, it's true. I couldn't do it. So. He's not saying it so much as I'm saying, like, I couldn't do that.
So if this is the case, why are you dragging your feet then? Because you are dragging your feet.
All right, that's what I want to know about that. Like, how am I dragging my feet? Like, I was dragging my feet on when I did my stream with the divorce papers. That's true. Okay. I was dragging my feet. But, like, ever since then, I've been accused of dragging my feet. There's literally nothing that I could really do. I can't. Today I was planning on like pursuing this. Like, this is not dragging my feet. Like, I will do this as soon as possible. Like, I don't understand why you would say I'm dragging my feet now. Like,
I'll tell you why. Because we were in VC for over an hour before the fucking stream. This stream's going on and on. So you are dragging your feet, because you could do something about it now if you wanted to.
You mean that, like, instead of being on VC, I should have been just out getting the annulment papers?
Done? If you want to. Don't want to, you don't have to do it.
So, but... So that's the point. Like, this is the point that, like, it's not just, I think it's not just about signing the papers. Like, it's about telling John, like, it's okay that I signed these papers. It's okay. Like, this is not a tragedy. It's good. And you were in VC and I didn't do that.
Do that again. That was a bit, You do a vague stuff where it's like I'm trying to work out in my head because you're talking funny patterns. It's all right, you know.
Today in VC, right, the point was, like, it's not just about me going to get these papers signed. That's not actually just going to, like, change everything. So I had an opportunity with John to kind of tell him everything was going to be okay and that he didn't need to be angry anymore. But I didn't do that either.
Do you not think sometimes that Benny's very impatient with solutions to problems? It's like, oh, we're going to VC, or we're going to stream, and we're going to sort this problem out. You guys have been at this for fucking over, what, 20 years? Something like that.
Is he impatient now? Yes, he's impatient. It's been like the whole marriage, and it's been 5 years of this intense stuff, which we're doing now. So yeah, he's impatient. Like, why wouldn't he be? And why am I, how does it make any sense that, like, I'm defending him against your thing? Like, okay, the truth is, like, I think he is a little impatient. I think he's impatient. I think he gets it in his head that, like, you can just, like, snap your fingers and, like, everything's over. And it's just like this one. And then he says, like, no, he says two things. He says, like, one, this could be over in a second. And then he says, no, this won't be over in a second. It's going to take a long time, and I don't really understand that.
No, I mean, he's nonsense. I mean, you know, I don't mind Ben. He's all right. He makes me laugh sometimes, but the man talks a lot of nonsense, which is all right. We all talk a lot. I've talked nonsense too. But it's like, you know, I think the problem with you is you think you put Ben on the pedestal when you sort of listen to all the shit he says. He's an idiot. I'm an idiot. You're an idiot. We're all idiots, dude. And it's like, okay.
But if I took your advice and I just said, like, fuck this stream, I'm not getting, like, let's just do this. I'm just going to go, like, try to get as much of this divorce and annulment stuff done today. In my head, I'm saying, like, he would say, like, no, that's not it. But I've been trying, like, I don't, like.
But no, that's exactly what he would say, because you can't do anything right. It would be like, If you come and he wants you to stream because he wants content, but if you actually go and do something, it'll be like, no, you're doing it wrong. And then if you did it, everything you do is wrong. This is the thing with Ben. Everything you do is wrong. If you go and work on your divorce papers, you're wrong. If you come and stream and don't work on your divorce papers, you're wrong. It's like, you know, you have to fucking. You're going to have to sort of sit there at some point and think, like, sometimes he's right and sometimes he's wrong. And you're going to have to pick some of this shit and decide which it is. You know, you're going to have to pick through the stuff he says and pick out stuff that is real from the stuff that isn't real.
Okay, but all right. So I think he's... I feel like he set this whole annulment thing up. He's saying, like, it has to be this certain way. Like, it can't happen any other way. Like, you need to be, like, in a certain place, like, which I would say I'm in, but he'll say, no, you're not. And, like, he'll,
But Courtney, I've known you for a few months now. He always says, no, you're not. He always interrupts you. And he always goes like, you've got it wrong. And it doesn't matter if you change your opinion. He sits there and he goes like, you're just wrong. Doesn't matter whether you agree with him or disagree with him. And I'm not taking your side over Ben. I mean, obviously, I speak to you. You're an annoying bitch. You're out of your fucking mind. So, I understand his pain, but at the same time, he's a dickhead. So, you're going to have to sift through it yourself.
But if I sift through it myself, right, and if I say, this is what I think, then he will say, then you've ruined this whole family. You can't, if I sifted through it myself, I would say, I can get this divorce and annulment. I'm happy to do that. But he will say, your kids' lives are on the line, which is clear from today, from what's going on. And that's true. Okay. So then he's saying, here's what you need to do. Here's what you need to do in order to fix that. Right. And then I try to do that. I feel like I'm doing it. And yet, it's not it. It's not it. I don't know, and he'll say, you do know what it is. You do know
what it is. Courtney, listen to me. Do you want to divorce him and get an annulment?
Yes.
Right. So what you need to do is think about what you want. And when he goes why don't you do this? Why don't you do that? Tell him to fuck off. I've never, ever seen you tell him to fuck off. Ever.
I mean, I think I tell him to fuck off all the time, but I'd like...
Yeah, but not you don't vocalize it and you don't go straight down the line. You need to be straight down the line with this guy and so tell him, why don't you shut up and fuck off?
Because what if I think he's right about what he's saying?
He's not always right. Now, Ben's sometimes right. And then when you acquiesce to the idea that he is right, then he dances around your fucking grave and goes I'm right about everything. I'm right about everything. He's wrong about some stuff. You need to fucking, again, you can take, there's a point of taking criticism and there's a point of going this fucking idiot's a retard. Just think about the thing. Don't you go through phases where everything that comes out of Ben's mouth you think is right. It's not. And not everything that comes out of your mouth is right either. So you need to sort of strike a balance. So if you want to get divorced and you want him out of your life, then tell him to fuck off.
Okay, but I do want him out of my life. I do want to get a divorce. I don't want... but that's not his, but then again, I don't, because I don't.
Yeah. This is the problem. You can't make a fucking decision, which is fine. Look, Courtney, I haven't spoken to my wife for 2 months, man. I don't know what to do. I'm not making a decision. It throws everything up in the air, and you want him out of your life and you don't want him out of your life. It's normal. That's normal fucking feelings.
I mean, maybe
at some point when he comes online and calls you into VC and tells you to kill yourself, you need to tell him to fuck off. Tell him to kill himself, stupid fat idiot.
Maybe I should just say, I don't want... Maybe that's what he's saying, I don't want you in my life. I don't want you in my life. And I'm just saying I want him in my life and I'm doing everything I can to keep him in my life. So maybe I just have to say whatever I need to do to say
you've got 6 kids. You're always going to be connected at some point, but would you like to get back together and be a happy family in an ideal world if you could click your fingers?
No.
So then he'll always be in your life. He's never going to go away. You got 6 kids with him.
Well, let me ask you this, right? He says, unless I give up on this thing that he's guilty of all of this, which I don't think he is guilty for all of it. And I can say that to all my kids, like, this is not your father, this is me. But like me saying it, like, it's like, I have to do something else. Like, but do you think that like he can have a relationship with them? Like, even if he thinks I'm not in the right place with that, do you think that like it ruins his relationship with all of the kids because like he thinks that I'm not in the right place with them?
Sorry, someone's calling me. One sec.
Yes, I'm dependent on him and I don't want to be, and he's telling me to get the fuck out. She'll get help. We're both against him. Like, let's just duke this out. I'm not going to hide behind like half truths or whatever. You don't like him. I don't like him. But we want to have it out with him or whatever. Or
what?
I don't know.
What is this?
I'm letting John take all the heat. And Tenderman is saying, like, you won't do this. Like, and John is like, at least he's being straightforward. At least he's saying to you, like, fuck you. Fuck this. I hate what you do to me. And he looks at me and he says, I fucking hate you, Mom, because, like, you just, like, you don't make any sense. At least John makes more sense than I do.
What?
Yeah, he makes more sense because at least he says what he believes.
What? It's totally crazy.
It's crazy, but it's what he believes, so at least that makes sense on that level.
I'm not going to believe a word of that. It's totally bananas. He starts insulting Grace for nothing. Gets up on his crutches, which he supposedly can't move on. Attacks her three times while she's videotaping it, and then comes on YouTube and laughs about how hilarious it is.
Yeah, but he believes that. He believes all that. He believes that she
believes all what?
He believes that she was wrong for the way she treated him. I don't think he believes.
No, he does not.
Then why did he attack her?
Yeah, I mean, he's deeply irrational. He thinks that, like, he thinks what you've told him is, I don't know. I don't think he thinks it's true, but he just can't understand what he's doing.
So you're saying
he's filled with hostility. The reason he attacked her is because she had a camera on. She was presenting him with the truth. She was defending
him. Are either you guys bailing John out? You both, one of you seems to be sitting around smoking a fag and you're munching crisps, dude. Are either you?
I don't fucking care. Not my problem. Bail him out. He wanted to go to jail. Let him sit there. He loves it so much.
Riza, I don't know. I think you wanted to talk to Ben. I don't know. He's still in the background. You want to say something for him to come back up here? You don't have to. I'm just saying. I'll shut the fuck up. I can't hear you. Well, I was going with this thing that Tenderman said, which was, don't lie, stop lying. And then Ben came up here and says, like, John's lying. He's totally irrational, which I think by implication means that, like, I'm lying. I'm totally irrational about everything. But I want to tell the truth. And people are saying, like, you're not telling the truth.
Heard my name was being slandered in here.
What's up, Grace? You fucking bitch. What are you doing? Getting your fucking brother stuck in prison. Fuck you, I watched that video. Show me your black eye, bitch.
It doesn't matter. He hit me pretty hard. I don't have any physical evidence of it. He came at me with his fucking crutches. He hit me hard. He hit me in the face. Seems totally crazy to me. First of all,
well, crutches. Well, I might give you some idea why he did it. He spent the last few days or weeks talking to you and your father in BC with both of them calling each other faggots and everybody telling each other to kill themselves, maybe a little bit stressed out.
Rini says, oh, so that gives them the right to attack me? Rini says, why did you go up there in the first place? I went up there to get some food. So then I went up there and I wasn't even talking to him. He came out and said something nasty to my brother Tom, and I was like, ugh, Tom, that guy sucks. And then he said, you know, maybe if you guys are nice enough to Tom, if you're nice enough to her, he'll suck you off. Tom was cleaning something up and John came out and it was like, you know, busting his balls. And then I didn't say anything to him. I said it to Tom. I said, like, that guy's being a real asshole.
Look, it's not like, look, all I'm saying is not like he fucking climbed on top of you and started beating you with his fucking crutches. I think he shoved you once with his crutches and then he knocked your phone out of your hand.
Yeah, but he attacked me. I could have, here's what I don't understand. It doesn't make any sense. He attacked me. I could have attacked him back in self-defense and I would have smoked him. He's on crutches. It doesn't even make any sense. Like, Grace, who attacks? Who on crutches would attack somebody? How does that make any sense? Like, I couldn't believe it was happening.
Don't you think that you were provoking him? You don't think you were provoking him at all?
I started.
Of course she was. Of course she was. You all provoke each other all the time. Look, man, if I lived in your family, you'd all have black eyes.
I turned the camera on because he was saying some wild shit. So I was like, okay, I'm not doing this privately. I don't care. I'm not doing this anymore. He's in an agitated state. He just told me that I might suck my brother off.
No. And it escalated. And, like, you didn't try to
de-escalate. I asked him what he said. That's escalating? I can't ask my brother what he just said to me when he insulted me?
What's your problem? Fucking faggot.
Hey, Tommy, if your dice turn up, maybe she'll suck you off.
After that, more escalation.
You always defend him. He attacked. You know this used to happen when we were younger. He used to punch me in the back really, really hard.
I know. I'm defending him in that sense. I think you provoked him. I'm not saying he was right to do what he did to you, but I'm saying what I saw was provocation on your part. That doesn't mean what he did was right. But I did feel like you were provoking him. And you can ask people you can ask other people, did she provoke him?
She did, but only into an argument, not into a fucking fist fight.
No, he started the argument. He started.
Yeah, right. Yeah, it doesn't matter. Look, you were arguing with him in VC before this. You were obviously arguing all the fucking time. So
provoke him into those arguments. He was talking over me, and I said, "Can you stop talking over me?" I didn't provoke him into anything. How could you take his side in this? Taking out his anger on me. Yeah, he does.
Yeah. Yeah, I think you called him a faggot in VC the other day. I think you do enough. I think you. I think there's a little bit of back and forth.
I'm going to hell.
I called you a whore and said I wanted to punch you in the eye and choke you out, and you just laughed at it.
No, Kevin, that's not true. Not an expert. That's not true. My mom is taking his side. She's saying that I provoked him into hitting me.
No, I didn't say that. I didn't say that. I said.
You guys are so crazy. He launched a massive insult towards.
He was being an asshole to my brother. I said to my brother, that you're a fucking asshole.
That's true.
But then he comes out and says, then he says, obviously, that's like kind of crazy to say.
Yes.
Like,
that's out there. Right.
Okay.
Right.
So then I start recording.
Yes.
Because a little baby, because he was upset, right? He was upset, so I was provoking him, right? I was up there making a snack, and he said, "Get out of my apartment."
Mm-hmm.
And I said, "I'm on the lease. I'm allowed to be up here."
Mm-hmm.
And then he came at me, didn't he?
Yeah. Yep, he did.
I mean, Courtney, I mean, I don't think anybody's saying that John's in the right. I think some people are saying, should Grace have called the fucking police?
No, Rizzo.
John was wrong to hit her every single time.
Would you come after somebody if they're recording you and they say they're recording you? He was like, I don't know what to do. I said I was fucking recording it. And he did it again and again and again.
But you know the situation that he's in. You know.
What's the situation? That he's a fucking asshole and I called him out on his lie and he wants to physically abuse me for doing so? That's what I'm supposed to be respectful for, of?
What John did was wrong. I think the only criticism of Grace at the moment is the calling the police shit. Because it's not just some dude you met in a fucking alley. That's your brother. And people are a bit like, what the fuck?
Why did... But he came, I mean, it's ridiculous, but he came on this live stream and he was sitting in chat saying, it was funny, go ahead, call the police. It was hilarious.
Yeah. So you taught him a lesson then?
What am I supposed to do? I'm supposed to just sit there and take it? What?
No, I don't know. I would never call the police on my family. It's a bit weird.
But he's called the police on my dad before for no. Well,
that's this is where you've all learned it from then. Or I don't. He called the police on your dad.
So should I have hit him back to prove my point? Should I have hit him back? I could have hit him back in self defense.
No.
He shouldn't have hit you.
So if I was going to say what should have happened, you should have played the stream. You should have played the video online to embarrass him. So he looks like a bitch hitting his sister.
He did. She did. She played it.
I did do that. Yeah. And he said, go ahead, but
that's what I'm saying. And that's where it should end. It was like everybody laughs at John. John's a little girl who fights with his sister. Well,
why shouldn't he be punished for doing that? He's an adult. He shouldn't do that. I have no... That's what the police...
Because you don't call the police on your family. That's why.
You call the police on your family if they're abusive.
Only if you're a woman getting beaten by your husband. Not if your brother pokes you with a fucking stick.
He didn't just poke me, though. You keep saying that. He hit me hard. And when... The last time he hit me...
Show me the bruise.
I don't have a bruise, but he did hit me hard enough.
Because he didn't hit you hard.
The last time he hit me, I genuinely felt like, okay, this guy's actually going to do this. Like, he's... He hit you hard enough that
he... Am I talking to Ben or Grace? What the fuck's going on? They provoke each other all fucking day. We were in VC for at least an hour and a half before this, where they were taking snipes at each other, obviously annoy each other, which is normal amongst siblings. But it's like, you know, who cares who started it? You know, they've been fucking brother and sister for years and years and years, and I'm sure they've annoyed each other the whole time. So it doesn't matter who started it today. All I'm saying is you don't call the police on your family.
He's out. He bailed himself out.
He wants a ride.
He wants a ride from Dad. Well, Dad said you'd call him, so why don't you call him right now?
I don't know if he should really just waltz back in here. He didn't even say sorry. He just said, you give me a ride or what?
Yeah, I mean,
you should put it on speaker.
All right, John.
Are you going to not respond?
I'm responding right now. I'm live streaming this, just so you know.
Okay, are you going to pick me up or not?
I don't know, John.
Yes,
like,
or no? Can you just answer me?
I want you to apologize to Grace for... Okay, he hung up on me.
Good.
He doesn't want to learn his lesson.
Why does he deserve a ride?
Instead of bailing their son out of jail, the family decide the best course of action is to continue streaming, as his misfortune has now become their content. MKUltra test subject Courtney Thorp and her handler at the time, Ben Thorp, are about to be slightly confronted by longtime viewer and streamer ProvoKid. His channel will be in the description below.
Is it true that I...
Today, Courtney, who won? John went to jail. Who won? Tell me who won. Who won? I won. Because you see life as a game, and your game is to try to torture me. But oopsie, you made a mistake, because now I have all the power. And if you need power... And that's the only thing that you're going to respond to. Well, you're going to get it. You're going to see what power looks like. What did the church in the Middle Ages do with people who taught lies? What did the Catholic Church do to those people?
They killed them?
They killed them. It's not the church. The secular authorities killed those people. Okay, and they just had a religious opinion that differed from the church's. Why did the church
hand them over to the secular authorities, and the secular authorities killed them. Why?
Because it was important what they were saying.
But you, in this situation, you can do the same thing, and I'm not going to seek the same pursuit. You can't do anything with someone who refuses to acknowledge their lies. Is that correct? This is Jordan Peterson's question, right?
Yes, that is
what
correct.
What do you do with a woman who has decided she's just not going to do it? And the answer is the same answer that the church had. You do your best to wipe them out of existence. And you think that's funny. Or you think, well, oh, no way. Let's have pleasant conversations. No, 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 no. That's not what happens. Spicoli, loser.
You start attacking Ben about making threats to John, but you didn't come on saying, like, what Grace experienced today was, like, John came after her. Like, why
are you going through all of this stuff to please
him? Cut her off? Are you going to cut her off?
Why don't you just tell him the truth? You don't do this for me.
You keep cutting her off?
Okay, please don't interrupt.
Why do you have to say please? All right, see the laugh, the coop?
Yeah, because you're crazy, Ben.
All right, right. Okay, the insult.
I'm laughing at you.
Okay.
Yeah.
Can I talk? I can't even talk.
All right. I got him off as soon as I could.
Don't fucking worry about that. You're great. You look wonderful. Sorry about all that drama today, Courtney. Let's change the subject. Let's loosen up.
No, I'm not changing the subject. Ben is saying I'm going to jail. You've been saying that in the chat. Like,
me? No, I haven't.
No, you said before, like, he's doing this, like, video stuff to get stuff on you.
Yeah, that was my initial conclusion.
And I said, no, he's not. No, he's not.
I said this 3 months ago, too, but go ahead.
And I said, no, he's not.
Uh-huh.
And now he's saying, like, now I'm going to, you're doing it online, and now I'm going to use that. And I'm like, okay.
He always was going to use it.
I don't think so.
Oh, Courtney. It's a long con. You've been conned. Sorry.
No.
You want to still believe he's not conning you? That he hasn't been building up evidence? Jesus Christ.
Yes, I do.
So why do you think he changed careers to a career where he now, like, if Ben was going to fill out child support, what's his income? You see that pivot? See that nice little, it's a long con. It's a long time to set up what he's done. He didn't.
No way.
No way, Courtney?
No way.
Please. You think he's trying to save your marriage with his YouTube idea?
He's not trying to save the marriage. He's not trying to do that.
What's he been doing? Starting
he's
a career?
He's trying to get his kids back, essentially. He's trying to get his kids back. That's what he's doing.
And the evidence bears that out, right? All he's done is bring them together in the past 3 months. Isn't that correct? They've only grown stronger.
Okay. But if you look at it like this, okay? He's saying, like, I'm going to use this to get my kids back. So it does follow in line. He's saying, I'm going to use this stuff that you said on YouTube to get my kids back, which is what he wants.
Which is, yeah. Sell it. It's all for divorce. To prove you are a certain type of person. He's going to paint you.
But he wants his kids back. He doesn't give a shit.
At the cost
about
of
what
you.
Happens to me.
Yeah, I know.
He doesn't. That's fine.
Yeah,
he
you're
wants
being conned.
Back. So it does make sense. I'm not conned. That's what he wants. And that's what he's doing.
He could have just asked instead of fucking making you look like a piece of shit, which is what he's been trying to do. You think he's been painting you in a good light?
Well, even in this conversation, like, even when Spicoli was saying, like, it's all your fault to me, he said, no, it's not. It's not. He's not interested in that. He's not interested.
In what?
He's not interested in blaming me. Because when he had an opportunity to, when Spicoli said, like, yeah, it's all your fucking fault, he was like, what? Real calm. No, it's not. It's not.
So because of that, you formed your opinion?
My opinion is he wants his kids back and he'll do anything to get them. So, yeah.
He'll do anything to you. Yeah, he will. He's been working really hard the past, not for you, but he's been putting you under a pile of rocks, so to speak. Slowly but surely, every day, putting one stone on you and another stone, recording it.
Well, you're saying, like, assuming that I don't deserve those stones. You're assuming that I don't deserve them.
Here he is.
Wait, I got to clarify something.
I love it.
I got to clarify something.
This show never ends.
You construe this as, I want my kids back. What in the hell does that mean?
It means you want your kids. That means that you want your kids to trust you and have a relationship with you, which you cannot have right now.
No. I have an obligation to protect my kids from evil. That is not a my thing. And I will take any and all measures to do so because I am obligated to do so, including legal recourse.
Why didn't you walk upstairs and stop John?
Anything you want to think of. If you set up a situation because you refuse to be honest, in which you are saying it's going to be a power game, then I will play the power game. And I will play it hard. Why are you, as soon as I blip off, creating an evil narrative with this moron down here about what I've been trying to do? I've made myself completely vulnerable to you. If I wanted to do what you say I wanted to do, I would have taken other measures from the start. I am not your father, but I may wish that I had acted like your father. He protected himself first. I have not done so because I have been willing to be vulnerable to you in the hopes that your fucking brain would come around. But you are now saying, so call your divorce lawyer right now. Take me for all I've got. Do it. Do evil.
I'm not going to do that.
Rain down the fires of hell on your head. They will not be on mine.
I've always said, I'm not going to do that. You can have all the money. You can have it. And I can.
You're just a liar. Why are you asking these questions about what I'm seeking to do on YouTube? Why?
I didn't ask them.
Why are you doing this?
I'm not asking.
Moron. Why?
Are you talking to me now? Why does he leave? What the fuck is that shit about? So autistic. And I never knew Ben was autistic, but when he becomes overstimulated, he can't stop peeking. Right? Like, you know, when people can't control it.
Why don't you tell this idiot the truth?
See what I'm saying? I'm
coping. Ha ha ha.
Look at you.
Why don't you tell this idiot the truth about what he's saying?
Hey, Ben, calm down.
He's going to talk over me, right?
Okay.
Why don't you tell this idiot, who's a nice guy, the truth and stop letting him lie?
Okay. Provo, you shouldn't be on my side. You should not be on my side with this one.
Nope.
Because I can tell you the story. I can tell you what happened to me. Okay. My mom fucked me up. I got married when I shouldn't have. I couldn't take the vows. Then I spent like the next 20 years blaming Ben for that. Ruining my family.
No, you're not going to do this thing that the truth is this long story. Tell him the truth about what he's doing. Right now.
Me? What I'm doing? What's the truth about what I'm doing?
You think you're right, but you're wrong about Ben, and you're insulting him and disrespecting him.
I'm disrespecting him?
Yes.
By how?
By coming on and coming at him about his son, and by laughing when he comes on and, you know, not taking him seriously.
He doesn't think he's telling the truth. He knows he's lying and doing about what? Evil.
Lying about what? Be specific about what I lied about so I can fucking respond.
He's doing evil instead of doing good. Why don't you tell him that?
Because... because I feel like I can't.
Look, see what that is? See what that is? What is this? What is this? I am what?
Confused because you won't can't no, answer my fucking question.
I am.
You cut me off so much. Why'd you cut me off? Why are you fucking cut me?
What is this? What does this mean? What is this a way of saying?
Hey Ben,
I am.
I'm confused.
I am
confused.
Hey, finish the fucking sentence.
Fine.
Then rot in hell. I don't care. Both of you.
Rot in hell. Why don't you rot in hell? Go kill yourself.
What a fucking annoying guy. Jesus Christ. So what did I lie about? Like, I'm so confused because I asked a question. Is his head like, can he not hear me? You can hear me, right? You heard the question.
What did you lie
finish
about?
The sentence. What is he doing portraying himself as?
He's
what
so
is
autistic,
word?
Cutting in and out.
Say the word. He's acting like a what?
Victim.
Me? I'm a victim? Of what?
You're acting like a victim of Ben when you're just doing this. You're not coming up against him. You're just saying like,
I can't cut him off. You told me you'd kick me.
You're just saying like, okay, guy, you got this one. And it's like a cope. And like,
it's a cope.
You're not really coming up against him when you do that.
In regards to
him just being there and talking to you. You're just kind of
in
like,
relation to what?
In relation to what he's saying. And you know,
which is,
he's saying that like you shouldn't interrupt him and that like you're,
even though he does that to me,
that you're being that like that what you that you came in like saying like what the fuck Ben with
he
your
called
son
me a bitch
right
several times,
and if you wanted to like really come up against him you wouldn't laugh and just throw up your hands, you'd just come up against him.
Okay, when someone like taps in and out on the screen and is like autistic and interrupts me, but gets mad at me for interrupting, like doesn't have the reciprocity, but knows how to tell you what they can't do. It drives me nuts. It drives me absolutely up a wall when I hear advice from someone who can't fucking do what they're giving.
Okay,
that drives me crazy. So I laugh. I think he's
crazy.
If
we could just do an experiment, if you wanted to talk to Ben, I bet you would interrupt him within like the first, if it wasn't.
Why are you doing experiments? Why don't you just tell him what it is that he's doing right now? Why will you never tell the truth?
Why don't you just do it for her?
I did tell him what he's doing.
That's what she wants me to do.
I did tell him what he's doing right now. Didn't I? I thought I did.
No.
Why don't you have the tone of voice proper to someone who's insulting the father of your children for nothing? Why? Why?
For nothing.
Because when I defend you, you say you don't want to be defended.
Yeah. Okay.
When I come at people,
you don't have anywhere. Okay, fine. Then prepare yourself. Pack your bags for prison, which is where you're headed.
But you did say that to me. You said I don't want you to defend me. You're not on my side.
I'm still so fucking confused. So am I a victim or like what's the like what am I doing wrong? Don't.
It's true.
Why are you just doing this long speech thing with this moron? Why? Why didn't you just say the truth to him? Why?
Because I'm trying to tell the truth to him. I am.
You're not.
But then
well,
I just
a little bit. You are a little bit. You are.
Okay. The truth. I mean, the truth is like I think he's a nice guy, but I think it's wrong to treat you like that.
No, I don't know why you have to say he's a nice guy. What is? My interaction with this man, what has it been for months now? What has it been? What is the truth of my interaction with this person? What is the truth? I know the truth. You know the truth. You won't say the truth. I will tell him the truth. But you won't.
I think the truth has been that
Why I think that. Just say the truth.
The truth is that you've been generous with him and you said, like, let's, you know, do stuff.
Why did you talk to him? Instead of making a why don't you tell him the truth?
Ben's been generous with you.
No,
and
don't start talk.
Ben's been generous with you.
You
and
should just write it down for you and make the show so much easier.
Help me. He really is. He's trying to help me tell you the truth. Now you're doing
something else. Tell this fucking loser the truth.
Please. I'm dying.
Okay.
Rhetorically.
I don't like what you're doing right now.
He's dying. He's
rhetorically,
dying.
Rhetorically.
He's dying from the truth, the prospect of the truth being told to him.
Suspense. It's good. So okay. A few months, he interrupted.
I told you what I thought you've been doing with John. I told you that, like, I didn't think you were really helping him.
Yeah.
Sure. I think that, like, I think you could have taken the Zoomer debates and really made it something of it, but you wanted to put it on Ben's lap and say it was his failure. And,
well, why don't you pick up on his little muttering, his little baby muttering? It was my fault.
Yeah, it was.
Tell him the truth.
It was your fault.
Why don't you say, what the hell do you mean by that? I set you up.
Man, Ben, I don't need to be set up. I brought you an audience. I don't need to be set up, buddy.
I promoted it.
I don't need to be set up, Ben. I
congratulated you for doing a great job. You gave me. You claim to be a victim.
I don't need.
You won't let me talk.
All right, sorry. Well, you keep cutting in and interrupting everything, so I'm a little caught off guard every time you jump in. So, like, the whole Zoomer debates thing, this idea, Ben has this weird thing where he gives every – we've talked about this before, where he gives people things that they don't ask for, right? And so, hold on. My general refusal of the gift is somehow rude. We're like, he made this thing, and he said, it's yours. And I said, I don't want it. And so many other people said they don't want it too, by the way. I'm not alone in this.
Okay, but, like –
So okay. Next point, you covered that one. Now let's move on to another one.
No, let's stay with the Zoomer debates, right? You said that you were interested, you wanted to do it, right? And but then why wouldn't you want to do it?
Because I don't do homework or work for other people.
But it's like we could have done it once a week.
Yeah, I'm not.
And you said you're interested, but you're only interested if he was doing it.
Yeah, because it's his homework. It's his job. It's his channel.
But then why were you interested in it all? Like, what was the interest to, like...
Because you guys were trying... Like, I thought you were pivoting away from your dysfunctional family content. I thought, great. What a wonderful idea. They're done shitting on each other. Maybe they're going to make real content. So that was kind of the whole thing. The whole thing was, this is better than ruining your family. So in my whole thought process at the time, I was like, oh, it's finally they figured out how to make a real channel with real content that doesn't involve... burning their family down.
Okay, but
to tell the truth, like Ben likes to say, when I feel like I see the truth, I'm going to tell you the truth. That's my truth.
Right, I've had enough of this. Courtney, do you want to keep doing this? He says, I tell the truth. That's what a liar says, because he knows he can't.
You said this.
Who at least respects the truth, not enough to say a sentence without saying, I feel like.
Should I say, I know?
All these other people in chat. Who are talking shit. Why don't you call them out? Tell them to come on up here and fail like this loser failed.
Thanks, Ben.
All right.
Yeah, you should say thank you. I'm trying to help you.
You always have.
Yes, I have.
I know. I'm helping you too.
You smile because that's what liars do. They smile. Go, hey
Ben, right? You know your big problem?
Why don't you say
your big problem, Ben?
Are you going to talk over me?
Yeah, I am, because I got something to say. My turn, little man. I've helped you so much. You haven't even said
now. You should respond to that by kicking this little faggot. Oh, I can't say that. This loser. When are you going to speak the truth?
I did. I don't know what this truth is.
No, you have never spoken the truth. Now, what is your plan for dealing with these assaults that you're going to get from this person who's trying to destroy your channel?
Well, he only came in as three people. I banned him all three times. I think I know what it looks like now.
Well, the answer is you need to have people cam up in the back room and confirm who they are. That's the simple way to do this. No non-cams. Okay, so you know that.
Yes, he was cammed up.
You're just not gonna.
Right. I will have them cam up. I won't.
If you're not familiar with somebody, then maybe today's not the cam day. That was obviously an AI. Anyone can see that.
It was.
You knew that was an AI.
I made a bet.
Always excuses for lies. That's what you're gonna do with your life. I think you do not deserve to live if that's what you're gonna do with your life.
But there isn't any.
Think someone like that deserves to live?
Isn't there any excuse for saying that I was in an intense conversation? I just wanted to bring somebody up and I just made a really stupid.
But you always make excuses for failing. Why don't you succeed? Then you don't have to make any excuses. You change your you change your story. You say, I didn't say that when you did. Why do you want to do this with your life?
I don't want to do it with my life. I want to tell the truth.
Your actions do not show that that's true. You want to do evil and lie instead of doing good. What would be so hard about telling that idiot the truth? And I know why. You know why you don't want to tell him the truth?
Because I want him to like me.
No. See, that's a lie. Because you protect feminine rage, which is what he has, which is what your mother did to you. You protect it, which is what your son did today. Feminine rage will lead to death, but you don't care. You are killing everyone around you who loves you because you will not speak the truth. You are killing your son. You are paving the road to his temporal destruction and his eternal destruction.
Okay.
But you don't care.
But I did text him today and I did try to tell him.
I want you to respond to that comment. Is that true?
I am paving the way to like his misery. I am.
And you can stop doing that by telling the truth and not lying. But you on this stream have been doing nothing but lying. And then you say, I'm trying. That's not, doesn't make any sense.
Okay. Did I lie to Provo? I tried to say to
yes.
Him.
Yes. Now you're going to say, well, they weren't lies per se. This is what liars do.
What was the lie that I told Provo?
You see, lying is not being I came up with full freedom, something which I knew to be not true and then presented it. That's not what it means to be a liar. The devil never lies that way. The devil tells things that are half truths. Don't you understand that?
That's what I'll do.
You don't think he threatened to beat the shit out of John? And beat his listen. He said, I'm gonna beat your fucking little F-word leg. He even called him the hard N-word, I think. He was like so disrespectful in the way he talked.
It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter.
To me, that sounds like a death threat.
It's over. You're going down.
It's a crippled knee.
I'm gonna figure out how to pay my taxes by taking it out of your wallet.
Jesus Christ, look how crazy this shit is. By taking it out of my wallet.
Yeah. Let's get real now, huh? Let's get real.
So I'm the problem?
Yeah, you're the problem. You're the problem for saying that, and I'm going
to
sue you.
Now you're doing this fake thing. Has to apologize to me for that.
I apologize.
Say it for real.
Say it for real. I apologize for saying Ben threatened to kill his kid. He did not say that. It was a joke.
No, that's not real. How do I say it real?
Oh, that is real.
Oh. It seemed like
liar. You don't understand what you're so full of lies. He said he took it back. Fine. I did not threaten to kill my kids. You said kids, Provo.
Jerome. I was speaking specifically Jerome.
Okay, but you said kids, so I did not
misspoke. I misspoke.
No.
I was wrong.
You lied.
I was wrong when I said kids.
You lied.
I don't think I lied. I did hear what I heard.
You lied.
I don't think I lied. Okay. I did hear what I heard.
We're back at legal.
I apologize. I misheard what you said. That's all.
You said, Ben, you threatened to kill your kids.
Bring your wife down. She's a lawyer. Bring your wife down. She's a lawyer. She will clarify this. You are putting your family in financial peril, in legal peril.
Ben. These threats aren't going to work. Again, they can work on your wife, but I cleared up everything I had to say. Before you cut me off like a psycho, Ben, here's what happened. I was in D.C.
Let me
clear this up because Ben seems confused. Let me clear this up. Everything I said before, right? This is where the story starts. I'm in D.C. with Ben, and he's verbally threatening to beat the shit out of his son, Jerome. This is the whole story, and I interpreted his jokes about Jerome's leg and what he would do with Jerome to be a real threat. I thought it was real. I thought he was really threatening his physical life when he said, I'm going to come upstairs and I'm going to beat that little F with me.
We're going to stop you there.
That's the story I'm telling.
So you think, so you have to say that I seriously meant that I was going to go upstairs, punch his knee by hand to the extent where his bottom leg was loosened from his top leg. Then by hand, I was going to rip his bottom leg off.
That would cause death.
Walk it. Okay, can I talk? Let me know when I can talk. Because you have a legal problem now. But if you want to go ahead and do this, we can go there.
I'm sorry for interrupting.
Okay, you think that was a sincere thing that I was going to do, that I was sincerely saying I'm going to then
in
rip
the moment,
his body. Okay, no. You've had a lot of time to process that. And you're saying that I was going to rip the bottom part of his leg off, walk it down to the wharf, and throw it into the Atlantic Ocean. That is, you think, qualifies. Because I've gone to the police for a death threat. You know what's required for a death threat?
What?
You need to have a real means of doing it and a real plan to execute it. That does not qualify.
In Ben's mind, he has now conquered his one-legged, crutch-walking bully. He is invincible. So when John is finally bailed out of jail and back at his apartment he pays for, Ben decides that he hasn't learned his lesson yet and decides there's a cripple in need of some physical correction.
So I'll give you the basics. So I was in my apartment. My dad came up. He wanted to have a power trip. And he basically said, I have no right to be in my room. Because there's no like official division of the space, because I pay 50% of the rent, but like there's no official division of the space. Like we didn't like make a rule like you can't cross like this border here or whatever, you know. And he said, you have no right to be in this room. I said, okay, fine, I don't care. You can come in my room if you want. And he came in my room. I started playing music to try to get him to leave. I was trying to de-escalate the situation, and He grabbed my speaker and smashed it on the wooden floor. And also, he threw a shoe at my kittens.
Yeah, I was unaware the kittens were there.
I told the police officers, I said, honestly, the number one thing I'm like freaking out about right now is what's going on with the cats. Because he said he would strangle them.
Yeah.
I do think he would drown them.
And then John started crying and said, stop recording, this is not a game.
Walked out of the room, hobbled out of it. And then I went down the stairs. I didn't even put shoes on. I grabbed my car keys. I went to my car. I had noise-canceling headphones on that I put on. I went down to my car. I just sat in there and put my headphones on and just enjoyed the events transpiring, which was my sister standing behind my car, not letting me back out. My dad screaming at me from the right window, and my mom screaming at me from the left. And then they left, and I thought that it was the coast was clear for a little while at least. So I took out the engine oil because my car has an oil leak still. And I haven't been driving in or keeping up with the oil, so it's just leaked all out. So I had to fill it up before I drove. So I went outside the car, I opened the hood. I started pouring the engine oil in, I undid the cap, and then they came down, one of my Tommy, Timmy, whatever you guys call him, I don't know if you know him. He had my kittens. He had my cat. My mom had my kittens. They said they were going to take them if we don't have a conversation right now. I said, I can't do anything about that because I physically can't. I said, you escalated the situation to this point where I cannot have a conversation with you about it. Obviously, like, what do you like? We're gonna have a conversation about this. So then my dad tried to grab the engine oil from my hands. And then he also grabbed the
he tried to grab the engine cap, the engine oil cap, and I actually ended up screwing it on and retrieving the engine oil that he stole. Then I slammed it and tried to get back in my car, but he was standing in front of my door blocking it. I was incredibly frightened that they were going to have the cops called on me because I touched him, which I up to this point I didn't, and I didn't touch him, and I was incredibly fearful of that happening because it just happened to me the day before. And they were taking videos the whole time and laughing. And then I walked away and tried to walk to the police station, but I realized that wasn't going to really happen because I was wearing socks and it was like, it's like rainy here. So like there's puddles everywhere and it was fucking crazy. Then I went back to my car. And at that point, I think he moved. So I was able to get in the driver's seat, but he blocked the door from shutting. So what happened from there was...
And pause. This moment in particular is important for a few different reasons. One, Ben said later that during the physical altercation, the recording somehow went off. Two, this is a fuck-up by Grace, as they wanted to pull away and stop the recording before showing any of the assault, but you can clearly see Ben about to kick his son in the leg. Three, we know that they really didn't want anyone to see this portion, as Grace would later upload an edited version without Ben about to kick his son in the leg.
Grace can show some of our conversation. Don't you have that?
Transition. Yeah, I do. Hold on one second.
Are you good at Adobe, Ben? Do you know how to edit shit?
You know, strangely enough, the only part that weren't able to capture the camera went off. And some people would say that's kind of this Epstein.
It's probably the most important part in regards
to the actual physical altercation. Yeah.
He started screaming at me to get out of my car and talk with him. I said no, and he came in the car. He put like half his body. He's put his whole upper body in the car, and was like bashing me against the center console, and like pushing my head back so like I could barely breathe, and like putting his elbow on my neck, and like it was like a lot of force. Like it wasn't like he was joking around. It was like. This was like a serious, like this, he was like doing this, like this is what he was doing. Like at first I was like, oh, I don't know. Like, I don't know if I can trust this guy's being honest, like with what he's doing, because he's doing like this content stuff, which is destroying my life. Cause he has like manic episodes about it now. So he's pinning me down, and, I take my phone out to try to record it, and he takes it from my hands because I can barely like move my hands at that point because he's like got me pinned in my car, and my car is pretty small. So he takes my phone and he throws it on the concrete outside, and he asks Courtney to pick it up, and she does, and she holds it from me. and then at a certain point, I was like. Like I thought I was gonna die. Like I thought, like at that moment, like he was going to just go for it and kill me. So I started bashing his head with my hand, and like frantically. There was no like rhyme or reason to how I was hitting him. I was just saying, like, I don't know what's going on, but I don't want to die right now. So I was like pummeling him as much as I could, and like trying to get him. I wasn't really pummeling him. I was like just trying to push him off mostly. And then, he eventually gave up and stood up outside the car. And my sister at this point had not parallel parked. She parked her car behind mine, so I couldn't leave. So they have my phone. They're not allowing me to escape. And then I eventually am able to shut my door, and so I turn my car on, and I do like a several point turn. It was like 7-point turn. I like had to like back up and back you know, whatever, like retard, because there was not much space in front of me, but I eventually was able to kind of get out. And my mom then decided to sit on the hood of my car while I was driving. And then she got off after like 20 seconds of sitting on the hood of my car to stand in front of it and threaten me to like knock her over. And then I sped off and I was like questioning whether to go to the police station first, but then I was like, I'm fucked. Yeah, like I'm fucked in every way. There's no other like I don't want to waste policemen's time, but like I'm fucked.
John would end up going to the police station and just barely getting there before his father could once again report his son for assault. Quite literally, as John showed up crutching into the station, Ben was pulling in screaming at him, knowing what he was trying to do. After Ben was processed for physically assaulting his son, he decided that this was content and thought the best course of action would be to go on infamous newsman David Walsh's show to talk about his arrest.
Dude, what did you do? Why were you arrested? Did you punch your son?
I don't remember exactly the things I said. I was going to murder him.
All right, you don't want to admit to it if you did. I get it. Don't incriminate yourself. I understand.
I said it's that a justice I system. Myself, if it comes down to it.
Ben, dude, what are we going to do going forward? I want to see you and your family fucking, you know, have some resolution.
Yeah. I do blame his mother for all this. I don't really think he has a problem with me, but he thinks he does.
Courtney, you mean to tell me Courtney, your wife, jumped on the hood of a car?
Yeah. Yeah.
She's a lolcow, always.
She's a real-life lolcow. Yeah. But at least I videoed it.
I don't know. Did she has an opportunity for YouTube gold, tube gold, or she really care? I don't know. I can't make heads or tails of
it. I don't know, dude.
Show them the papers, man. Something
about disorderly.
People want to see. Backing it up.
I should get that framed.
Yeah, you.
You got the right to remain silent, motherfucker. Yeah, well, actually, it was weird because there's like a one of these papers here, I have non-contact. And where'd that go? Here it is, no contact order. So, because I have a no contact order, I realized that Grace has a no contact order. But he was kind of like, well, if you're not in the same place as him, then, you know, he was like, well, I don't know if you got to, you know, I don't know if you should go back there. But then he was like, well, okay. And then I was like, well, wait a second. If I can't go back there, how can he go back there if Grace is on the lease with him? You know what I'm saying? So then I was like, well, so I went back and I was like, well, wait a second. If I'm going to go to jail, if I contact him, then how is he going to, I mean, and this was the whole origin of the thing. We got to sort out. So yeah, we said like, you can't go back there because if Grace calls, then you spend the night, at least a night in the actual state prison.
In the end, a man who thrives off long format MK Ultralight conversations with his family members for YouTube ended up with a no contact order for his son with a no contact order for Grace. I wish I could say something, if anything, was learned from this experience with Ben. However, the next month we'll see Ben steal his father's last will and testament in order to try to get more money from him. It turns out not only does Ben's son bully him, but his father does as well. Who can really blame them, though?